Baller Alert. Got no problems with Baller Alert, but everybody on Baller Alert and anybody else out there talking shit about me, here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the Chocolate Starfish!
Meerkat Mall.
All I wanna see is violence.
Dog.
You don't know how inside of my mind gets.
Dog.
Shut your mouth, close your eyelids.
The chap.
Pay your price. I'm not surprised that I lived his life. Could you do what I did and do it twice? Could you make your money up and tell a lie? Could you come and say that bit in our name? Could you work around the clock all night?
Dog.
Yeah, could you work on the job all night?
Meerkat Mall.
I'm drinking.
You almost lost your job tonight. This not breaking bread, I bring my motherfucking part. Yeah, I love the feeling when it's wrong, alright. You sick and twisted, know my brain, alright. It's on autopilot, let it fly all night. But don't let it go crazy, don't let it turn into a lie. But don't get so that crazy that it's stabbing with a knife. Like it with all the voices, you don't let them tell you lies. And you probably see a demon if you look me in the eyes.
Ladies and gentlemen,
me in the eyes. You see my eyes bleeding. Oh, that bitch give me head, that bitch give me brain. I feel like a mind reader. Ooh, look up, it's a bird, look up, it's a plane. No bitch, it's a desert eagle. Got the niggas on pins and needles, on thin ice like ballerinas. I ain't playing with they bitch asses. Little tunch, I split acid. Small feet, but I kick asses. Call me your bitch ass. I've been on the job 24/7. I keep the AK-47. I'm a cheesehead, but my heart yellow. I'm outside like Coachella. I might drive her throat wetter. I fly by and leave no feathers. Rock a white beater in cold weather. Brown skin, nigga, I'm a gold medal. I'm a white. On demon time, all these diamonds I can't even see the time. Pockets they be on dinner time, Thanksgiving time, November slime. Judge always trying to give me time, give me fair time, and that's plenty time. And I ain't got time like the end of time. I kill a nigga like I'm killing time. It's me and A.E. was handing. Sick and twisted evil bastards. Smoke a nigga wear the matches and let his mama have the ashes. Moolah.
All you wanna see is diamonds. All I wanna see is violence. You don't know how inside of my mind gets. Shut your mouth, close your eyelids.
Don't you join a world that you can never live a life? Don't it feel amazing when you playing with the spike? I know you feel crazy when you put it on your life. I know you getting lazy when you say you'd rather die. I know I'm getting lazy when I say I let it fly. Pull up with the Martians and they know I'm about to fly. I do this for my life.
All this money, you get trifling. But I'm trifling cause some of bad time. But it's also perfect time. It can silence a reminder of all the shit you said when I'm behind you.
Pay your price. I'm not surprised that I lit his life. Could you do what I did and do it twice?
Hey, hey, hey.
Your money up and tell a lie. Could you come and say that bit in our name?
Could you hey.
You get mad.
Ooh. Could you work on a job all night?
All right. We're gonna roll the long intro this time.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing.
Yeah.
You piece of shit! You piece of shit! I don't see color!
This is the longest intro of all time, man. And there was like 20 more seconds to go. God damn it. Welcome, everybody. This is Swaycast 19. We're going to catch up on a bunch of shit today because the guy was acting up and also he got in like some... I don't even know what to call it. Is it a beef? If it's like, I guess, one-sided and super passive-aggressive? I don't know. Well, he was crying about somebody spreading misinformation about his opinions on the Elden Ring DLC. And also other very important things. to society, the economy, and overall the global state of the world. So, yeah, that's it. Welcome, everybody. Let me change the layout. And let's see where we're going to get started from. I kind of wish I could do the Elden Ring first. Even though I really don't want to, because it's fucking cringe. I hate it, man. I hate his fucking take on the Elden Ring bullshit. Because I've seen some clips from it, and it's so obnoxious. Let's watch some other stuff first. Let's wake up those Americans that are still sleeping around or lying around in bed or haven't even gone to bed yet. So Review Tech USA, a little bit of a follow-up on him. He had his whole drama with his boyfriend, Jay, who kind of looks like a skinny Review Tech USA. Yeah, it's weird. And what happened? Nothing. They got in a domestic dispute. They got into a divorce, and then Rich paid him fucking child support or something. I don't know. He paid him what he owed him. So now everything is good in the Review Tech USA cinematic universe. That was the season finale. It was very anticlimactic. And yeah, yesterday, this is, we can do this real quick. Yesterday, we got a fake member actually trolling for the first time ever. We got a legitimate troll attempt. But of course, it's not going to fly with Mr. Burnell. He's been trolled for over 20 years now. This shit ain't nothing to him, dog. So what happens is this guy gets somebody send him a video. I think it's GCW. So yeah, that's some wrestling promotion. And somewhere in the video, he starts skipping. It's around here. It's very fun.
Weren't really there.
Look at this. So now he starts skipping, and then what we start seeing,
we're wrestling and they weren't really there.
We start seeing the little thumbnails that happen down in the video. So you can see in the right side. Let me try and enlarge this for you, because Derek likes things enlarged. Let me capture this, copy this. So let's try and analyze what is happening in this video right here. What the attempt at troll was, because it was very funny. So here on the right side, we definitely have Derek holding on some type of lingerie. In the middle, I think we have a girl with an afro that is like spreading it wide open. She's giving it to everybody. And on the right, on the left side, we have some more Derek again. Yes. Oh, it's the afternoon in Eastern Europe here. So I can get as horny as I want with no regrets. You Americans need to chill out. Go to bed or wake up or depending. Anyways, this is it. Later on, I don't know what happens in the video because I don't think anybody has found the video. So we can't really watch the whole thing. But it seems like it's a very decent attempt at trolling in ways that many people have pointed out before. You can troll if you happen to get a membership or you just use the Argentinian exploit. But DSP busted him, dude. This could have been like the funniest moment on DSP Reacts, and instead is just like a failed troll.
What else? What are we watching? Sucks. What the fuck?
Yeah, it's straight up some girl getting clapped.
There's other bad things in the video.
There's bad things in the video.
You saw that, right? When I fast forwarded. So whoever submitted this video was hoping that I was going to play that and basically like get banned on YouTube. You saw that, right?
Probably wouldn't get him banned, to be honest.
And I gotta ban them. Okay. Good thing we didn't watch the whole video, huh? All right.
And look at how proud of himself he is. Oh man, it's like an assassination attempt that got dodged. He's like the next Castro.
You saw that in the thumbnail, right? I'm not seeing things.
He's a Phil Del Castro. There you go.
You saw that, right? So hold on a second.
They're about to terminate him.
Actually, I don't have to get.
But you know, that's the thing with Darkseid Phil, that one of these days, he might just get terminated by something like this. Something super random is going to happen to him, and he's just going to get his whole channel deleted. And probably he's going to manage to get it back after the fact.
Get up. I'm right here on my laptop. Okay. Pardon me while I ban someone on YouTube quickly.
Pardon me while I ban take someone. Care of this. Okay, now we have a banning break.
Some idiot tried to do that, and they thought that I was going to fall for it. Hold on.
Dollar alert. $2.99 from Slater Gaming. Argentina allowed me to catch you live finally.
Hey, big ups Slater Gaming. Maybe it's the time difference too. But recently, I haven't had time or possibility to stream, so I'm just taking every possibility I can to catch up. And yesterday, we got a fucking storm out here. I got my internet and my electricity going on and off every, like, 15 minutes. It was the worst shit.
So let's find who submitted this.
Big ups, Slater Gaming.
Here we go.
Okay, did he get him? I think he did.
They're funny. Like, they deleted it so that I can't find it. Yeah.
Oh, and they deleted it. You see? Oh, they actually kind of trolled him. Right. Now they're wasting everybody's time.
I'll have to check into it later and try to remember who that was. Because, yeah, basically this person posted up this video pretending like it was something it's not, misnamed it, right? And it's not. It's basically some pretty bad stuff.
But what was interesting to me, if we look at the data of the video, can we see it here in the end? Okay, let him finish talking first, and then I'll go back.
Probably no one has caught on YouTube yet, is what I'm guessing. And that's why it's allowed. So no one really caught to see what it really was. So I'm going to have to take a look and ban them later.
Uh-huh. He's not going to be able to find it. If they deleted the comment, he can't find it.
Video here. Yeah.
Because, I mean, we're talking about Dark Side Phil here. He's not exactly Inspector Gadget or Sherlock Holmes.
They probably did it on purpose. Okay.
Yes. No, they definitely did it on purpose. Because you can see Derek is there on both sides as a chick is being, is having a lot of fun.
Well, that's sad.
Very positive.
Like that. But I'll have to look into that and take care of it. And what I'll do is I'll just keep my eyes peeled.
And the thing is that DSP probably knows that that guy never even paid him the full, like, $20 for the Ultra membership. Or was it an Ultra membership? I don't know which one it was. But it's most probably an Argentinian exploit.
For this show, I'll have to basically fast forward through each video that's submitted just to be sure some idiot doesn't try to do that again. Right? So there you go. Yeah. What an asshole. And I guarantee you, too, this is a fake, probably someone who did a fake membership, too.
Yeah, there you go. A fake membership. So here what it says in the beginning, when he starts the actual video, there is the title of the video. And it has, I think, like 600 views. You can see it here. 980 views for one day ago. So how did they do that? How did that happen? If you know, most of the video is just troll bait, as you can see here on the thumbnail, is just a chick. Like, going full on, like, reverse cowgirl. And Derek, I don't know how they did the whole, like, views thing, but who knows, man. Very interesting. Could be bots as well. Yes. Now let's go and move on to the next thing. Let's do the coverage of the quickest things, the shortest clips. Let's see this one where Kat didn't want to get in an elevator because I think she was scared for... I don't know. I actually don't know. Let's find out. So this is from the day off segment. And we're also going to find out what he did on his day off this week, which I don't think is anything interesting because it never is. Unless somebody steals his grocery bags or something bad happens to him.
I like to call Phil's day off. Let's talk about what I did yesterday on my day off, shall we? Because we actually have some interesting and positive updates to give you guys. All right. First of all, yesterday was a very busy day. Where I was absolutely running around doing errands all day long.
I imagine the Benny Hill music playing in the background and him running around like it's a Scooby-Doo scene. Like a Scooby-Doo chase scene. But with clown music. Like this kind of stuff. They're running around from door to door and being chased by like the tax man and stuff. The way he explains his day off is like, a 1,000,000% comedic.
Okay. As you can see, I got a haircut was one of the errands that I did.
Oh, yeah. It's terrible, by the way. I think I have an obligation at this point to always talk about his haircut whenever he gets one because it's always bad. So there you go. This is your his haircut is bad segment.
Absolutely. Running around doing errands all day long. Okay.
Yeah. Look at this fade. I mean, this is not really a fade because it cuts off.
As you can see,
it's not like faded, it's just not.
I got a haircut was one of the errands that I did out of many. We had to restock the house because we had actually been out of a lot of commodity products, like paper products and things like that.
Paper products, yep. They got on a paper plate run. supplier on.
We had to go like Costco.
These dudes are such fucking like weirdos, man. Like instead of using actual, you know, ceramic, plastic, whatever bowls and plates that all you gotta do is just wash them with water. They're living like two people in a household, but instead they're gonna live like they're actual high schoolers and buy themselves fucking paper plates.
And many other things.
For a dude who is obsessed with coming across as a mature adult, like he is obsessed with it. He loves telling you how mature he is. He is so much more mature than your favorite rapper.
So we were out and about for a very large portion of the day. And it was tiring to do that. But the weather was nice. It was actually sunny and cool. So we had some good weather for it. While we were out, is there anything notable to really mention from when we were out? Just a couple of things. First thing, we just happened to be at the local mall because we were going to actually eat dinner there. And we happened to just walk into Sears.
Okay. Oh, what was that weird?
Just a couple of...
Every time I start watching these clips, especially the Hate Army clips, because he puts like three cameras that are out of sync with each other, I notice like some new and innovative tics that he has developed. It's like an actual tweaker. You can watch The Wire, and you're not going to see that many tweakers that tweak as much as he does.
First thing, we just happened to be at the local mall because we were going to actually eat dinner there, and... we happen to just walk into Sears.
Look at this. Like, what the fuck is this? It's almost like he's swallowing mid-sentence.
Okay. Now, for those who don't know, Sears, or Sears Roebuck and Company, is one of the longest-running department stores in the United States of America.
Bro, are we actually going to talk about Sears?
They were synonymous with, like, the big shops.
Is this content?
In the United States, you had Sears, you had Macy's, you know, those kind of ginormous department stores. And... some people in chat, very rightly so, are saying Sears. Sears is still open? Yes and no.
25 Norwegian krona from J-Dog. Give me your feedback so I can power trip on it.
Oh, dude, now you reminded me. There's a suggestion box segment from yesterday, and I really like to watch it. I'm going to watch it later after the Elden Ring shenanigans because it fucking sucks. But yes, I'm very curious as to what the feedback was this time. Could it be option one... Phil receives feedback about the podcast being too long and a bunch of unnecessary segments are a part of the podcast that he should cut so it becomes more digestible. Or option two, the feedback is that he's doing everything correct and he should never change anything.
Oh, okay.
Or option three is, I don't know, suck a dog off.
Suck a dog off.
Yes and
that's,
no.
That's the actual suggestion.
Oh, right? Basically, Sears is on its way out and going out of business. All right. But there's three locations left, and my local mall has one of them.
Oh, did he actually read Ann Lee's suggestion? Like, really? Oh, that's going to be interesting because I read it last time. I wonder what he thinks about it.
Oh, my wife and I hadn't.
I'm sure that segment is going to be so annoying. It's going to be so, so infuriating.
Been in Sears in like a couple of years.
After. I can almost imagine it. I can manifest it in my brain.
I think we were looking for slippers for me in like the fall because my slippers had worn out, and we know that department stores are sometimes places that seasonally have them. And we had gone in there, and even
seasonally
then,
like, have slippers. We
there, they were massively understaffed. They barely had, you know, like the product was very disorganized. Right,
what? Bro. You just went to buy fucking slippers. Stop crying about this shit. Just buy the slippers and fuck off. You're a mature adult, right? You don't have time to cry about how Sears is a mess.
Door was in shambles. So we go in there just on a whim to see...
Oh my god, he's so mad at random companies.
Wow. Is all I have to say. So we go into this Sears. And at the door is exercise equipment. Now this doesn't make sense. This is the ground level of the mall... where any department store on ground level is supposed to have all their...
$2 from Redbird UJ76. TBS not the same with your sarcasm, just saying.
Well, thanks. I'll be back next time. And then I'll be gone the next two times. Hold on. I'll be gone from this Sunday to... the Sunday and Thursday, I'm going to be gone next week. Because I'm going on a vacation to Turkey. Blah!
Clothing and everything, you know, their high-end products.
It's going to be very fun.
A bunch of exercise.
I think...
Huh? And then we look past that and there's appliances. But then we look past that and there's one row of shoes. And then we look over here and there's some clothes. And then over here we see jewelry. On the back wall, we see tool chests. We're like,
bro, what? Why are you fucking crying about? Like,
what
actually,
is going on? So we
actually, what is he crying about? That they put the different products in unusual places that you wouldn't expect to see them?
Actually walk further into the store and we realize half the store is closed off, roped off, and completely empty.
Okay.
They used to have a big shoe department in the back. It's gone. They've blocked the entire department off. It doesn't.
Yeah, maybe they're fucking broke as fuck. They don't have money to do that shit.
Exist anymore. The whole left-hand side of the store is taped off with that yellow hazard tape saying do not cross.
Okay.
And they're like, holy shit.
What is his problem with it? That's what I'm trying to understand. Sure, it's a chain of stores that is failing and is probably going to end up closing sometime soon. And when you walk into the store, you get an idea of that. Okay. Sure. That's exactly what I expect.
The whole kiosk where you used to check out and customer service removed from the store doesn't exist anymore. Okay? Like, wow, what on earth? So we're like, well, I wonder what's on the other floors. We walk up to the escalator. The escalator up is closed, broken, and they're not going to fix it. The only way to get from floor to floor in the store is to use an old rickety elevator.
Oh, this is it. Yeah, okay. So that was the buildup was to say that Kat didn't want to get in the elevator because it's old. Or she's too fat or something. I don't know.
And I was like, well, I would like to use the rickety elevator, but Kat actually looked at it and was like, I really don't want to use it. I was like, really? She's like, yeah, I'm actually terrified that elevator is going to break on the way up or down.
Kat being epic as always.
And I welcome you here to the show.
Oh my lord!
As we already have Jasper to buy we had no idea. Because the way this store looks, like it looks like this is a store on life support. Like it's going to die any second. And I don't want to go in there and be the story on the news that people got stuck in this year's elevator. And I was like, all right.
I think a very underrated reaction to the Kat re-reveal was a piece of peace with ALT, but piece of peace in particular, when he just like he sees her and he's like, oh my god, she's fat. Oh my god, she's fat. And it's like, it's not even an insult. You're just acknowledging this, right? It's great. It's also along the lines of Tevin's, which is basically like, oh my god, she's really a BBW. So many fun reactions, man. So many fun reactions.
I guess we won't then, because I wanted to actually see if there was stuff on the other floor. Because the thing is, if clothes, shoes, tool chests, appliances...
Bro, just shut the fuck up. Go to a different store. What are you doing in Sears? And all you're doing is crying about how much it sucks. Just go somewhere else. I mean, in the US, it's like 24/7 open anything that you want to find. You probably have a Walmart that is open like 380 days a year. Like, chill the fuck out. Stop crying about it.
Is an exercise equipment are all on one floor. What else could be in there? I know that they have like housewares and like bedding. So that's what I was thinking. Like maybe there's housewares, bedding, and maybe underwear and stuff like on one other floor. And that's it. They used to be three floors. Sears used to be like the one-stop shop. Back in the day, they had everything. I mean, anything you could think of for your house was at Sears. Even electronics. They would sell electronics, games, consoles, stuff like that.
Okay, well, now they got it on Amazon, so you don't have to go to Sears. So they lose money, so they got a downscale, and that's it. Chill the fuck out.
Music system.
Why is he tweaking out over the past? This is like him crying about that Blockbuster closed down.
TV.
And talking to you about how bad of a company they are. It's like, dude, we fucking know.
These, you know, all the appliances in your home, like, yeah, the tools and stuff like that, housewares, you can buy all your stuff for your kitchen in there, everything for your bathroom in there, your bedding, everything. Like, they literally had everything in there. Lawnmowers, yeah. They had everything you could think of. It was everything at Sears. Big prominent company.
Okay, we get it.
They somehow managed to run themselves so far into the ground, they're not coming back. I mean, that was like, it literally reminds you of like going to like a hospital, right? And going to see people who are sadly are on the end of their life and they're on life support just sitting there saying their last goodbye.
Just like Panda Lee was sitting there on life support. And he ate her sandwich. That's my favorite part of the story, man. Girl was having a panic attack. Has to go to the emergency room. They give her like a sandwich or something. She didn't want it, so he ate it.
God.
Oh man, that fucking story, that whole thing is like the epitome of what Darkseid Phil is all about. He's just a fucking self-absorbed piece of shit that only thinks about himself, and anytime he does something even remotely decent for another human being, he needs to dangle it in front of their face. They need to know that he's a good person. He needs to tell you straight up in your face that he's a good person, because he did something good for you, and now you need to do something good for him.
I believe it, because again, I go into Sears my whole life. When I was growing up, I would go to Sears with my parents, and it was a—
and again, we're still reminiscing on the past.
I was like, what the fuck happened? How did they fall that far? They used to have the Sears wish book. Does anyone remember the Sears wish book at all?
No. Wait, is he drinking cherry flavored seltzer water?
How did they fall that far?
Can't see very well from the green screen, but it looks like it.
The Sears wish book. Does anyone remember the Sears wish book at all?
Yeah, look at this. It's cherries. It's cherry seltzer. Oh, I wonder if he thinks that it helps with his gout, because it has like 0.5% cherry juice in it. And also, this is a very good pause.
This used to be at the end of the year, Sears would send out a catalog to your house, and it would have all the awesome products that were available for sale at Sears in one thing where it lists them all. And the whole purpose of this catalog was that you and your family members would go through the catalog and select things you're interested in as a Christmas present. So you would give it to your family.
Bro, I hate these segments. They make me feel so old.
Family members, but also other people in your family would do it, and you would exchange.
It's like he's talking things that happen in like, you know, during the Soviet era. So they had like 1980s.
Wish book wish list. I did it every—
oh, back in the Soviet era, we used to line up in front of the bakery for a piece of bread, and it cost like 1 cent. And nowadays, you can suck a dog off.
Here, so my mom would give me the wish book and say, well, anything in here you like for Christmas? So I was like, I want this action figure. I'd be interested in this game. Now, the thing was, you didn't know half the time what the stuff was. It was like some photographer would come in and like film the action figures posing and stuff. And the games, forget it. I actually distinctly remember games would have the wrong screenshots. It would be like,
oh, dude.
Oh, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle.
So we... What is this? I don't get it.
Truffles Phil got Ket so paranoid that she can't even get on an elevator just shows the pignosis is real. Big ups, everyone. Please talk about my wife, Mia Cat Mob, who...
Big ups, dude. Yeah, Cat not wanting to get on the elevator. For some reason, it's not even the most interesting part of this story. Plot twist, this story doesn't have an interesting part. It's fucking terrible all around. But what I can't understand is how did we get to this part where he's talking about games having the wrong screenshots? So he started talking about going to Sears and that it really sucks. And then his wife didn't want to get on the thing. But then he started talking about how much Sears was good back in the day. And you had this catalog. And then we're talking about video games having wrong screenshots. Because maybe they're in the catalog? I don't know.
And it would be a screenshot of like Mega Man. I was like, what the hell is that? So obviously they didn't have the best editors or whatever, people that weren't into all the stuff they were selling. But they had everything. They had, like, again, things that you would not think. Guns. There were guns in that.
Hell yeah, brother.
Knives.
Like, hell yeah.
They shouldn't see. We're all in this wish book.
They shouldn't see.
Family, everyone would select what they
want. Kids shouldn't know that knives exist or guns.
Want for Christmas.
They shouldn't be seeing that.
They'll order it or you...
Because they might order one. A kid might say, I want this gun for Christmas. And then you gotta buy it.
Could go to the physical Sears store near you.
Get him a shotgun.
As a Christmas present. This was part of Americana. This was a major part of American culture, a tradition everyone was doing around Christmas every year. And now Sears is dead. It's like, how do you go from being that prominent, that you're actually a part of most people's American Christmas lives and traditions, to not existing in the span of like 30 years? That's wild to me. Like,
how did DSP do that same thing in the span of 15 years? That's very interesting. That's even more interesting than Sears. Because Sears actually has expenses. Actual expenses. They gotta pay people. They gotta buy product. And Phil is sitting on his ass for 15 years. He got so much fucking money. He got so much money. And now we're just barely getting by, barely existing. He had like a $5 stream the other day, by the way. A $5 stream.
What a horrible mismanagement. If anything, it just shows they did not know how to
very true
the internet age. As soon as the internet came out and everyone started doing stuff online, they just
so he just is just basically projecting about himself, because it's the equivalent for him.
£4.99 from Andrew R. Put this in the Baklava Fund, Meerkat. Hope you'll have fun and come back mega positive, ready for endless meaningful content.
Yeah, well, we'll see. It's also a business trip, so you know it depends. I'm not just going there for fun.
That was
because if I was going for fun, I wouldn't be going to fucking Turkey.
The end of that.
But big ups, Andrew.
But anyway, so that was eye opening and
super eye opening, as you can see on the still look at this, so eye opening. We got three DSPs with the most open eyes in human existence. So epic. This one has been done. Now let's dive into the whole Elden Ring shenanigans, right? I'm going to tell you what I understand from this whole segment. So this guy, Josh Prime Gaming, made this video 3 days ago. And as you can see, it's been taken off. You know, it's been relatively hot. Video is called Elden Ring DLC is overpriced trash. This is a quote by DSP. And on the thumbnail, it says Elden Ring is a scam. Admittedly, kind of a clickbaity. I wouldn't say directly clickbait until I actually watched the video, but it is a very clickable video. And then DSP started actually tweaking out about it and writing paragraphs and paragraphs about it. And I think he had a segment on his podcast crying about it. So I want to get all this context and know what the hell is actually going on right now. So let's start watching this video first. Let's begin from the beginning.
The DLC is $39.99.
Because otherwise, I'll have to go and watch his entire, like, 20-minute, 40-minute segment on this.
You charge just $40 for 10 hours of content, right? You can buy Elden Ring.
And, by the way, very interesting thing that happens here. Remember a couple of weeks ago when the news came out, or at least the rumors came out, that Xbox was going to go multi-platform? They're going to port some of their games on the PlayStation. Well, he cried so hard about everybody speculating and basically being curious about how that's gonna reflect on the gaming industry. But now he is sitting here and he's speculating and he's making shit up out of his ass.
To case Marge, Phil expect a schizophrenic Arab man to kitten on your door for disrespecting dead companies.
Who is Case Mullidge? Let me look him up in a separate tab in case it's something naughty. It's a guy on Twitter. And it's a investigative journalist in corporate wrongdoing, free speech, freedom of press. I believe in Ryan Cohen and Bill Pulte. I have no idea who this guy is. But it seems like he likes America because he has the American flag on everything. So good for him.
For like 10 bucks, 5 bucks. I do feel like that's kind of a dirty trick.
Well, here we go again. Elden Ring's DLC trailer hasn't even been out for 2 days now, and we already have some of the dumbest takes regarding the price, the quality, and today's take is coming from none
Shout
other
out to
than...
the new plug. Are you more of a bong, blunt, joint, or dabs kind of guy? Dabs used to make me a slug laying back and watching episodes of Cops all night. I hate my wife.
I'm more of a joint guy, because I like rolling. It's very fun. It's like a little ritual. You know, it's a lot of fun.
DSP Dark Side Phil. He's saying that From Software are price gouging the base game so that they can capitalize on it. Basically, he's approaching the realm of slander at that point, because what he's claiming is not even close to being accurate. And then he's complaining that the game is too expensive. And we're going to dive deep into this. Trust me, it is a pile of cringe. If you're new to the channel, this is kind of my thing. I love roasting dumb takes and journalists. So you're going to be seeing a lot of this on the channel. I absolutely love making this type of content. Let's see what crap he has to say today.
Shows some stuff. I don't want to spoil too much for those who don't want to be spoiled on the DLC. It shows various bosses of the DLC that look interesting. But the thing that really gets me, and I think everyone right now is scratching our heads about, okay? The DLC is $39.99.
So, you just look at it as an expansion pass. It's probably going to have a shit ton of new areas and a hell lot of a content. So the problem is exactly. I don't get it really. Because like in this case, you're thinking more of like, man, I imagine how big this thing needs to be if it's going to be $40 instead of, man, it's $40. This is not a Ubisoft expansion. It's not a DLC for Assassin's Creed Valhalla. It's not exactly the same thing. But of course, he wants to have hot takes. He wants to have something that he feels that he's the only one to bring up and everybody else has ignored. And that's what makes him the best in his opinion.
It's the most expensive DLC FromSoft has ever sold.
Okay, maybe it's the biggest.
Okay.
For one of their most successful games of all time, if not even the most successful game that they've ever released.
So, that being said...
And this is also the guy, like, if you think this guy cares about money and spending money smartly on video games, this guy buys multiple editions of the same game across different consoles just because he feels like it. He bought 2 editions of Street Fighter... He bought the most expensive edition of Yakuza Like a Dragon. What was it? The thing. Infinite Wealth. We got, I think, Mortal Kombat. I think he bought the most expensive edition just because he wanted to play early or something like that. Yeah, this dude is... Come on. He's not the guy to be on a soapbox, on a pedestal, talking about how expensive this is. He's the most anti-consumer person ever. Why would you even listen to him? Like, a lot of his opinions should just be dismissed based on the fact that it's DSP having them. And if you know enough about him, you can just disregard everything he says about certain topics. There's sometimes that he's right, and there's sometimes that he's right in segments like this, but the whole thing is that he's DSP. And even if he's right, he doesn't practice what he preaches himself.
With that...
And I think the peak example of that is the mobile games. Because this is the same guy admitting that he's been addicted to mobile games. They're terrible. They're the worst. They're anti-consumer. They're exploitative. And then again, he keeps playing them and he keeps spending money on them. So he can say all these things that he wants. He is technically correct, but he's not the right guy to be giving that opinion.
Price tag on it, right? You have to believe it's going to be incredibly long. If the main game was $70 and was 80 to 100 hours long, obviously, you would expect that a DLC that's $40 is going to probably be around 40 hours long. Now, you could be wrong. Maybe they're going to rip everybody off. Maybe because they took 2 years to make it and they've decided...
Phil, what you're doing right now is exactly the same thing you hate people for. You speculate things, right? You're rumor-mongering for the clicks and for the attention. Why are you doing this? You hate on people who do this. What if it's bad? What if it's like the worst thing?
Blow it up as much as they have, you know, hype it up this much, maybe they're just gonna rip everybody off.
And, yeah, maybe. Right.
Already I have to cut in, because when in the history of From Software has From Software sold a shitty product since Miyazaki took over?
Dark Souls 2? I think people don't like that generally because Miyazaki wasn't a part of it and it's different from the other games, but I guess.
It doesn't happen.
Because like when I think of something that FromSoft has done that is bad, or at least has generally be accepted to not be very good, I'm thinking Dark Souls 2.
All their DLCs, all their games are worth the money. And then he's saying that they blew it up and they're trying to hype it. FromSoftware has literally been quiet about this for 2 years. They're not even trying to hype it like that. It's like they had nothing to show because obviously a lot of work went into this DLC. At first, I was kind of surprised that it took that long. But once again, when you see the trailer and you see the quality of the product they're about to put out, I don't mind waiting another 4 months at all. And 2 years was well spent if it ends up being the best From Software DLC of all time. The way he should see this is that this is kind of Elden Ring 1.5. It's not a simple DLC, but rather an expansion.
Sure, yeah.
I don't know.
That's what I'm thinking too. I mean, because like, considering that there's places in Elden Ring that you might not even stumble upon for most of the game, and then you come across that place and it turns out that it's a huge like underground dungeon that is like a custom made, you know, it's not like random generated or generic. It's just like it's a fucking random dungeon. You go into a well You go down, all the way down, and it just reveals to you a whole different map. Considering that's the type of shit that happens in Elden Ring, I have trust in FromSoft. Now, if we're talking about this being a DLC from Ubisoft, I wouldn't have trust in anybody.
If you buy that sucker and you beat it in 10 hours, people are going to be pissed as shit. Like, are you out of your fucking minds? You charge just $40 for 10 hours of content, right? And that's the thing, like, typical DLCs for FromSoft games clock in around 10 hours long, right? Take a look at the expansions for Dark Souls 2 or Dark Souls 3. They're not that lengthy. They're good, but they're not.
Yeah, but those games are not open world. And when you do a DLC for an open world game, you need to put in a lot more effort than you would for a linear experience.
That lengthy, typically.
And like, I don't know why he decides to like speculate in a negative direction. And also talking about the thing that it's more unlikely to happen. I think there's about like, let's say 80% chance that this DLC is very good and is packed with content and everybody likes it. Because it's just based on the pattern of what FromSoft been doing with their games.
$2 from Lord Kane 666. Yeah, there's a lot of regardedness with Phil.
Yeah, well, it's here. There it is. I'm looking at it. I'm looking at it.
$5 from Frosty. Been on thirds this whole month. I'm glad I finally caught a Swaycast.
Yeah.
Face the stream is sponsored by Silver Spoon Spoon.
Maybe plastic ones if we can't find silver, but anything counts.
Who buys AC cord for every $70 every
year
and always buys the most expensive edition and always falls for the high product.
Legit. This dude also bought like the WWE 2K games just so he can play the half-baked career mode. So yeah, I mean DSB, come on, bro. You're not the pro consumer guy. You're not the guy who can speak for the people because you're not a part of the people. You don't like the people. You don't act like them. You don't share the same experiences. You're out of touch with the people.
They've gone for around $20.
How are you going to speak on their behalf?
That's a big ask.
Gosh, this guy is such a moron for comparing it to a DLC like Dark Souls 3 and Bloodborne. The DLC for Elden Ring is 60 gigs. It is basically the same size as the main game. Now, Miyazaki said that it's roughly a little bit bigger than Limgrave, but like I explained it in yesterday's video, Miyazaki always undersells and overdelivers. He did the same thing with the base game, said it took between 20 to 30 hours to complete, and we all know very well that it takes a lot more time than that. It's like this guy loves to be a contrarian for some reason. He always has to find a reason to bitch and moan about everything in sight.
Okay, now also, they're selling a special edition of the game that includes the original Elden Ring, also packaged with the DLC, and that's going to sell for $79.99.
Okay. Bro. Do you know how much the fucking the Skull and Bones game costs? I was shocked to find out. This shit costs like hold on. Skull and Bones price. The absolute shamelessness. The shamelessness. Oh, it costs $59.99 United States dollars, but it costs like $79.99. Euro.
$2 from Kopsai Default.
These motherfuckers are tweaking.
To try to speak like an advocate for the consumer when all he does consume product and get hyped for next product and chill.
Yeah, exactly. That's it. Because it's in his best interest to do it because he needs to make hype for his own stream. I understand that idea. You don't want to be like playing games that you hate and have the whole fucking thing be about how much you hate the game, even though he's also done that. But like being like everybody else, like those shills and idiots, but trying to pretend like you're not is where I have a problem with him. Like, I understand if you try and be mostly positive towards games so they can keep giving you like fucking review copies or whatever. That's just the game. I don't like it, and I take those opinions with a grain of salt, but I understand where they're coming from. But this dude, he's trying to pretend like he's above that. He's much better than that.
Okay, so that's $80. For the complete package of Elden Ring.
Sound
the
good.
The weird part about that is you can buy Elden Ring for like $10, $5.
Where? Where can you buy it for $5?
You find discs of it every.
Discs. Well, sure. I mean, you can go on Facebook Marketplace and buy a slave for $10, but that doesn't mean that it's a normal thing that happens. I think the most I've seen Elden Ring be discounted is the price that I bought it for. I think it was €29.99.
Everywhere online for cheap. You know what I mean? So essentially, they're overinflating the value of the original game back to $40 just because you need the original game to access the DLC.
They're overinflating the value of the original game to $40. The original game's... What? But the price hasn't changed. It just gets discounted sometimes. I mean, if you can find it from somebody on fucking, I don't know, eBay or something for $5, sure. But that's not really a retailer. That guy doesn't have permission to sell it for $5.
And I don't know if I agree with that. I do feel like that's kind
of... No, he's just full of shit. It's just the kind of shit he says to make it seem like he's making a point. But the moment you just pay attention to what he's talking about, it's not making sense.
Of a dirty trick, you know? If you're someone who played the original, good for you. You could just easily, you go right back to the spot to access the DLC for free. But what about people who maybe now I'm jumping on? So now I got to pay $80 to play the full game? Why? The original game is supposed to be like $5-$10.
What?
And then if I bought the DLC, so this should be...
Why is the original game supposed to be $5 to $10? Where is he getting that idea from? And this whole thing about people just jumping in is like, man, I need to spend $70 in the full game. Just play the base game first. If you're just jumping now, you can spend like 80 to 100 hours in the base game before you even think about buying the DLC. Like, it just makes no sense.
$35, you know what I'm saying? So what they're doing?
No, I don't even think the CD key sellers are selling it for $5 to $10. I don't think the game, if I go to g2a.com, which is where I buy stolen keys from because I'm a criminal, and I look up Elden Ring and I close all the pop-ups. Elden Ring. We got... Yeah, look at this. Look at this. Even on G2A, we got Elden Ring PC Steam key, $50. Discounted from 64, this minus 21%. It's all these discounts fake as fuck to make it seem more interesting. But still, Elden Ring PC Steam key global, $75. Pre-order bonus, $477. This is the only thing that has something to do with like $5. And then we're selling straight up an entire account for $43. So tell me about it, Mr. Brunel. Where can you find this for $5 to $10? Or how do you think that this game is valued, the market price of $5 to $10? When, like, thinking about it from a business perspective, if your customers... Imagine you're a sandwich shop and you sell the Miyazaki sandwich. If your customers are buying the Miyazaki sandwich like it's the next big thing at $10, why would you discount it to $1? People are buying it already. You see? And it's not in your best interest to do it. Every once in a while, when you have like a Christmas promotion, you can sell the Miyazaki sandwich for like $6. And then you can give the customer some value and they can feel like they got something out of it. And then you get something out of it because you sold a bunch of Miyazaki sandwiches.
They are monstrously inflating the value. In fact, I'm just curious.
You're just curious.
How much is it now?
And now it's like they're inflating the value. Yeah, look at this. That's what I'm talking about. I bought it around one of the dips when it was discounted on the PlayStation 5.
100% a lie. The price has been extremely consistent. $60
from Kopsai Default. Lowest I have ever seen Elden Ring for was like $30 or maybe $25.
Yeah, me
on
too.
Steam, and it's the same on CD Keys, Green Moon Gaming, or any other PC resale store.
Yeah. You know which games go down to $5 to $10? The shitty ones. The ones that nobody wants to buy. So they're trying to get rid of the keys that they got on, you know, CD Keys or G2A, and they're just trying to get some extra sales. You know, games like fucking like the Saints Row reboot. Games like that get massive decreases in price. Not Elden Ring, one of the most critically acclaimed games of the last decade.
US, and if you're in other regions or use a VPN, you might see a different number, but it has been very consistent.
Yeah,
it
this is it. It's a consistent price.
In January of 23, and it dropped in July of 23, October 23, and January of 24, and now it's back to its regular price. This guy is just spreading so much misinformation, either because he doesn't want to do a minute and a half of research, or because he's just being dishonest. Like, where can you buy Elden Ring for $5 or $10? That just doesn't exist, unless you're buying it from a crackhead down the street that robbed a gaming store. But
well, he might be. He might be buying it from the same crackhead that he gets his crack from. Because his opinions are definitely brought to you by the crack pipe.
Besides that, there's no way...
That's his main source. When he cites his sources at the bottom of the video, it says the crack pipe.
For $5 or $10.
How do I go to the page for it?
Yeah, now we can't even do that.
I don't know how you see it on PS5, darn. Because I wanted to look at information, is it? No. I was curious what...
Look at his fucking droopy, melty face, man. With the alcoholic, droopy-ass nose, with the snort sacks, droopy as fuck. The jowls, the mustache that looks like it's dripping off his face. Like, it's painted with a Sharpie, but he got too sweaty and is starting to drip around his face. That's how it looks like.
On PSN right now, right? I don't think I can find it. Honestly, PlayStation Store.
The huge caveman eyebrow that is just casting a shadow on his eyes and nose. That's what I'm talking about. That's the good shit.
I own it, so it's not going to show me how much you have to pay for it, I don't think.
Oh my god, come on, get to it.
View product.
Please be able to find it. If you can't find it, it's the most miserable segment ever.
It won't show me. Yeah, because I already own it. It won't show me how much it costs.
Just look it up on your phone, man.
Which sucks, because I would have liked to see. I can tell you this, they already put him on here.
Because this dumb motherfucker, he's trying to make a point and be like a gaming journalist. And he can't even find a single fact. Not a single fact. He can't find how much the game factually costs at the moment.
It's already here. Holy shit. Yeah. So Shadow of the Erdtree Edition is $79.99. And they have a Shadow of the Erdtree Deluxe Edition, which also includes a digital art book and OST. That's it. It's just a digital art book and OST, and it's fucking $20 more.
There you go. Here it is. Not that hard, is it? You pull up the actual PlayStation site. There we go. $59.99. I don't know what they're inflating or conflating or deflating or inflaming, but looks good to me. And they got a premium, I guess. I don't know what this is. So the Shadow of the Erdtree expansion, and you get some, you know, digital art book in a gesture. Wow, you get a free emote. And then we got a combined edition for $79.99, which is a good bargain if you've never actually played the game and you want to go into it. You might as well just get the full package. Sounds good to me.
Dollar alert.
$5 from Poxwalker. This specimen can't navigate a store page, lol.
Right?
What a hardcore gamer.
This dude is so confused all the time, man.
Crazy.
All the time. He's just phenomenal.
No, Phil, it's not.
Big up Poxwalker.
Not that crazy that the pre-order page is already there. It's called marketing. When you do marketing and you're showing a trailer for something, you want people to be able to buy it right away. Keep in mind, this is the guy that went to business school, right? I don't know how he doesn't understand that. The Steam page was available right away for pre-orders, and the PlayStation Store was updated, as it always is, in the afternoon here in the US. And of course,
how I imagine him going to business school is that he was the only guy in the class. And every time they had class, the only thing that happened was the teacher wrote the word business on the whiteboard, and he just pointed at it for like 45 minutes. And then that was the whole class. Because that's all that he's learned from business school.
Page is going to be there because you want to capitalize off the hype of the announcement. You want to take in as many pre-orders as possible. It is a business after all. I mean, I don't understand why he's so surprised by that.
The trailer came out like 5 hours ago. It's already fucking here.
Yeah, that's how it works.
So anyway, so there you have it. I don't know how much they're maybe they're going to charge $40 again. Maybe they reinflated the cost of Elden Ring, because I know it wasn't $40. Last time I checked, that thing was going for real cheap, and now it sounds like they're reinflating the value of the game again.
What's a real cheap? Like $5? It's never been out for $5. Get off this shit. Just say you were wrong.
There are collector's editions as well. I saw one that has an actual statue of Mesmer the Impaler, right? And someone in chat was saying there's another higher end edition that has a fucking a helmet or something. A helmet. And that's what I want to do. When I play Elden Ring, I want to wear the helmet, all right? But I will say this. In honor of Elden Ring's DLC announcement today, if we hit the $100 tips goal on either of my streams,
oh my God,
the knight's helmet, this, the Umas helmet.
Dude, this dude is so greasy. He just spent let's say 5 minutes shitting on it. And then immediately, we're using it as a gimmick to make money. Off of an announcement for a DLC for a game. He's not even playing it now. It doesn't even come out soon. Come on.
Today.
This is the god of manipulative marketing strategies. What the fuck is this?
The hat.
Well, because I talked about this on the podcast, I'm going to wear this specific hat if you give me enough money.
There you go. Excuse me.
There you go.
So, yeah. That's a hell of an announcement.
So yeah, that was
straight up monetizing speculation at this point.
That was his shit take of the day. To think that the DLC is going to be 10 hours and that From Software is
okay. So here's the thing. This video is clickbait because I mean the title is a quote from DSP that he didn't say. That is Elden Ring DLC is overpriced trash. And then the thumbnail is Elden Ring is a scam. But his take on it was really bad and obviously fucking wrong. And the guy in the video told him why, and I agree with him. So I forgive the clickbait. I forgive the clickbait. So I want to see Darkseid's response to this. Because here we got a very nice juicy paragraph that he wrote. I'm going to have to read it, I guess. To all the people being sent here by a hack YouTuber who purposefully edited this podcast to make it seem like I said the Elden Ring DLC is a scam, I did not. Oh, hi, Mark. Never happens anywhere in this video. Speculations that it could be a scam, but also could be amazing, is not the equivalent of the clickbait bullshit this idiot made about me. Leaving comments on this video is a waste of your time because they will not be published and you will be promptly banned. Perhaps actually watch my real podcast with massive... Yeah, I bet if he could go even larger letters, he would do it. You can increase the font size. Which isn't edited to exclude 30 minutes of me being hype over the DLC. You spent 30 minutes hyping up the DLC? For real? Really? Damn. Planning to resume my second run and make content around it, and you'll understand how stupid you look right now. Thanks! So yeah, you can see a serious fucking cope. I don't mind this video also because, not just because I agree with the guy, I agree with him, DSP's shit take, but also because it fucking rubs DSP the wrong way. So he got super upset over it. And... oh, here we actually got a clip from it. Big ups, Snortomania.
How about...
so this is... okay, I guess his follow-up... his follow-up is literally 20 minutes long. So let's strap in. This is going to be a very fun ride.
We start at the beginning, meaning going back to Wednesday, because I want to address something that apparently happened on my day off that I wasn't aware of, but happens all the time. As you know, there's a ton of people on the internet who just basically are out to always make me look bad, no matter what it is I say and do.
Why is he dressed like this? Why is he wearing, these formal shirts on the podcast? I will never understand it. He looks like he's dressing up to go sign divorce papers.
Nobody wants to wear a helmet playing Elden Ring. Die desperate to reach helmet goal. Yeah, I remember grinding my feet on Eddie Murphy couch.
Yeah, bro.
Constantly misrepresented.
Nobody wants to wear a helmet.
And I'm constantly...
he needs an actual, a knight helmet. Imagine if he gets that. Because the whole knitted hat, it doesn't fit him. It's not good. It's trash.
Held in a negative light, even though there's really no valid reason for it. Now, if there's a valid reason for it, that's one thing. But we've got a case here where literally, apparently, there's a group of people who are really angry with me.
Who?
And I don't know why, because literally...
The Elden Ringers?
It didn't happen. okay? Let's recap.
But I mean, bro, he doesn't even acknowledge when people are angry about things that actually did happen. Because he just doesn't own up to it. And he always discredits them. So even if this fucking happened, he would just say it didn't.
Go back to Wednesday's show, all right? On this very show, the Level 1 Podcast, back on Wednesday, I had a big segment about Elden Ring's DLC, The Shadow of the Erdtree. At that moment when I record the podcast, which is starting around 11 a.m., okay, 11 a.m. Pacific time, all right? I talked about everything that was known at the time about this DLC. The price, the features, because we had seen some of those features shown in the release trailer, and speculation. At that point, 11 a.m. Pacific time, the trailer for this DLC had only been present on the internet for 4 hours. It had released around 7 a.m. There was no other information. Everything was speculation. Now, what ended up happening was, over the course of the day, more information was released because Miyazaki, the guy behind Elden Ring and other FromSoft games, was interviewed. And when he was interviewed, he gave a ton of additional information about the DLC that was all positive stuff that, number one, is exactly what Elden Ring fans are looking for, and number two, actually answered a lot of the questions that we posed together when we were talking about this DLC back on Wednesday.
So it almost makes it seem like he cried in advance without knowing the full picture, and then he was wrong. And they told him he was wrong, but he's not happy about it.
So let's recap.
But what happened about all those people that cover speculation and they just ramble on and on about it for the clicks and the views and the stuff? And they should wait for the full story to come out. It's interesting that when DSP does it, it's okay and you find an excuse for him. But when somebody else does it, we jump on him immediately.
Originally,
and we don't even say whose name it is. He's dissing people left and right without anybody knowing who that is. He's just taking random shots.
When we were talking about the Shadow of the Erdtree DLC,
it's like he's doing a drive-by, but he doesn't know where his victim lives, so he's just pulling up on the whole block and he's just shooting at everybody.
Right? We were talking about some of the things that we actually saw in it, which included a new boss, some new gameplay.
Wait, what was this?
Shadow of the Erdtree DLC.
This is gonna work really well in slow-mo.
We were talking about some of the things that we actually saw in it, which included a new boss, some new gameplay elements, etc.
Boss.
Who is Mesmer the Impaler, right? The fact that you can access the DLC when you find Mikella, and Mikella's body is in that rotted cocoon down in the Moog's blood palace and stuff
like that.
Sure,
yeah,
so
yeah,
basically,
yeah.
We're discussing all of that in detail, lots of hype. And by the way, if you put it into perspective, the entire segment was hype. My entire border...
But bro, I thought you were anti-hype. I thought the hype people was doing it so the companies can like him and they can get clickbait views.
Wednesday.
And now he's like the biggest fan of hype. Now he prides himself on being hype.
Was Elden Ring. In fact.
Come on.
If I could just bring it up quickly. Let me find it. Well, now of course I can't find it because I want to do it fast. Now I can't find it. Oh, here it is. This was my border on Wednesday. Now, if you don't think that I'm hyped for this DLC and I'm positive about it, why would I make my whole border characters from FromSoft games?
Well, that kind of sounds like you're shilling then. Because he would accuse those same people. If somebody did this and he stumbled upon it and it had like 100,000 views, he would be hating the shit out of that guy. He would have a segment specifically for this guy and wouldn't even mention his name.
Elden Ring at the top.
But DSP can do it. He can have like 40% of his screen covered by an advertisement for a game that he's gonna play, and that's perfectly fine.
If you're not even aware, which you might not be, Elden Ring was my runner-up for Game of the Year when it came out. It was a very close battle that year for what game was gonna win Game of the Year for me. I love Elden Ring. I'm pumped. I even said in the podcast on Wednesday, hey, I'm actually gonna be playing Elden Ring again in May because we've had a playthrough that we were doing of it last year. It was my second ever run. It was a magic-based run. We had gotten...
Oh my god, the fucking DSP context is the worst. He tells you everything he has ever experienced about a certain thing. Even if it doesn't make sense. So here, the idea of this, the build-up to what he's probably going to say, the whole point is for him to tell you that he really loves the game, so... he couldn't have possibly been negative about the DLC and had a bad take about it. It couldn't have happened because, dude, I love the game.
DLC's coming out.
How did I say it's gonna suck?
June 21st. Hey, now we have opportunity to say, let's bring it up and use it. They were very, very positive, right? Just okay, go back and respec and use it. That's a great thing about this game, right? So I'm under the impression that most of the things I said about the Elden Ring DLC on Wednesday were very, very positive, right? The one thing...
No, it doesn't matter if they're positive or negative. What matters is that they were wrong.
That was a question mark for me, was the price. It's a $40 DLC. That's the most expensive ever expansion for a FromSoft game, or I should say a Elden Ring a Soulsborne-style game.
An Elden Ring Soulsborne-style game. You can just say a Souls-like. I don't know why he doesn't like selling Souls-like. I don't know why. It's so confusing to me. Because he says it like... when he's referring to something that is not a FromSoft game, but is a Souls-like, he's going to say a FromSoft knockoff game. And in this case, you're just saying like Bloodborne, Elden Ring style, FromSoft style.
And in previous iterations, if you looked at the price of... DLCs that they had released, I think the most expensive one had been like 20. Don't quote me on that.
Five Brazilian reals from Rodrigo Marcandez says, questions we posed together.
Yeah.
Anything he does has to dodge any kind of accountability. We didn't do anything together, Dave.
Yeah, now he can't even... That's a good point. He's pretending like now everybody was talking about it. Him and his chat, and they all agreed. And then people attacked them, not him in particular, which is the case, but it's them.
And usually the DLCs would be around 10 to 15 hours long, so I'm thinking, man.
Yeah, but those games are linear, Phil. This is an open world game. You need a lot more stuff in it.
This DLC is $40. You've got to think it's probably going to be pretty lengthy. Like if the original game was $70, well, if it was 60, I can't remember. But and the original game was, you know, 80 to 100 hours long. Then you would think that this DLC would probably minimum be 40 hours long, right? Maybe even longer than that, right? But again, my question was, I don't know. I'm curious, you know, how long this DLC will be. Hopefully it's not a ripoff. Hopefully it's not, oh,
dude, you know what? The thing is that now that I'm thinking about it, what happened to him is what he tried to do with those dudes that speculated on the Xbox stuff. He tried to call them out on the lack of information that they had and how their speculations are bullshit and are for clout. And now what happens with him is somebody is calling him out for having bullshit, ignorant speculations. And he can't take it. Oh, you see, this is a perfect example of him dishing it out but not being able to take it. And also, that other video got like 30-something thousand views. So it must hurt him extra.
Because we realize there's so much hype for this DLC that we're going to charge whatever we want, right? Now... I know for a fact that Elden Ring has been very inexpensive to buy.
You don't know for a fact because it hasn't been.
I just don't think it's been the digital version, but I know that Elden Ring's been inexpensive to buy because I've seen copies of it listed online for very cheap, like $10 or $20.
Yeah, that's probably a negotiable price. Or maybe somebody just getting rid of it, bro.
Okay.
Would you buy a used copy of your game, Mr. Burnell, or you buy everything digital and brand new? He doesn't buy used stuff. Because that's beneath him.
But what happens is these digital marketplaces overinflate the price of the games and never drop them.
Uh-huh. So, maybe because they determine the price of the game, Phil. Not Facebook Marketplace or eBay.
Dollar alert.
$2 from Frosty. Was Bloodborne Old Hunters a ripoff, Big Roach?
Maybe. Maybe, I think. Well, he had a lot of fun with the Old Hunters DLC. Because that's the one where Ludwig is a part of, right? And he had a great time with it. Great time.
During the actual show, I attempted to...
Yeah, and he also mentioned that it cost $5, but now it's 10 or 20.
Go into the store and see what's the price. And
you see, we're just changing the whole narrative.
Couldn't figure it out, and people revealed, oh, it's still $40. I'm like, wow, that's kind of a lot. 2 years later...
How is it a lot?
$40 for this game, all right? But actually, if you look online, you could get copies used for like $10, $20. I've seen it actually like clearance on sale online for like $10, $20 new. But it depends on the time of year and where you're buying it from, okay? But anyway, so this is what we talked about on the show on Wednesday.
Oh, by the way, is real quick. Somebody bought his wife a Neckphone toilet seat set. They legitimately fucking did it. Now they're both gonna have Neckphones. They're gonna look like the most ridiculous couple alive. And it's really interesting that he's having people buy gifts for his wife, like an actual cuck. and he's just taking them. Like, he doesn't see anything wrong with that. Somebody else giving your wife gifts.
Very, very positive.
It's so embarrassing.
I'm excited for this DLC. It looks great to me.
But at least now they're both going to look like two turds in a toilet.
And I'm very...
It's like skibbity toilet, dude. All the Gen Alpha kids that are like 10 years old, they're going to tune into DSP. It's going to be so much fun.
Oh my God, mommy, I'm watching the skibbity toilet guy.
Looking forward to it. I'm already making plans to return to Elden Ring in May because of it. So that's where we left it, right? So yesterday, as you know, I check comments that are coming in on my videos from time to time. I have to approve a bunch of them. And I start to notice a pattern. All of a sudden, I start seeing a bunch of really negative comments coming in on my podcast from yesterday. I'm like, what is going on? Where are all these negative comments coming from? All right. And they're all around the...
And now, of course, the narrative is that he's the victim. Feel bad for me. Don't think about what I said. We're not going to clarify that. Focus on the part where people are angry at me and I'm treated unfairly.
Topic.
That's a very nice narrative, Phil.
Okay.
It's a three-act structure.
You are misinformed about the Elden Ring DLC. Why are you spreading mass information about the Elden Ring DLC?
Mass information?
See, what is this hot take that you have about the Elden Ring DLC? It's completely wrong. You're an old dinosaur who doesn't know what he's talking about, and you're just trying to create clickbait.
All of this is true. What? All of this is true. And he is trying to create hype because he offers people to put on a fucking Elden Ring hat and he puts on the Elden Ring layout to get people excited for the game. Come on. All of this is true, by the way. Except mass information. I'm not exactly sure what that means.
What? So I went back and I looked at the video. The title of the video is like huge gaming news, Elden Ring DLC. It doesn't say... Elden Ring DLC sucks. Elden Ring DLC is a ripoff. You know, it doesn't say any of that. It's actually a very positive titling of the video. If you actually look
surely
at the description
AOT
of the video, there's
the
timestamps. It'll tell you directly.
He's been really?
For years and no manga can support he left publicly. Damn, we lost another one.
Yeah, man. You know what? I think it's him. I think it's him. The biggest cat guardian of all time. He finally broke, man. He finally broke. He started sending gifts. He started simping in real life. You don't come back from this, man. You don't come back from this. I think we can remedy it with a date with Jenna.
Where to start watching?
You know what?
My segment.
Maybe that's going to work.
Elden Ring DLC. Okay? So, there's really no excuse for someone to be misinformed about what's said in the podcast. It doesn't have a clickbait title that's erroneous or negative for the sake of getting people...
Wait. What? See, what is the excuses for misinformation? Okay, I'm very curious about this because he shits on everybody else for 1% of what he does.
There's timestamps. It'll tell you directly where to start watching my segment about the Elden Ring DLC. Okay? So, there's really no excuse... for someone to be misinformed about what's said in the podcast,
Phil, you are misinformed. That's the point.
Doesn't have a clickbait title.
Doesn't have a clickbait title.
Negative for the sake of getting people to click on it. And you can easily...
Well, I mean, YouTube titles exist to get you to click on it. The title and the thumbnail are the things you look at first and then decide whether or not you're going to click on a video. That's just kind of it.
Access that segment of the show by looking at the timestamp in the description. And so I'm like, I'm really confused. So I continue to read the comments. And it's so ridiculous. It's like, so you're slamming the Elden Ring DLC for being $40, but how dare you slam a DLC that's 60 gigabytes in size, the size of the entirety of the map of Limgrave, a DLC with 10 boss fights, 8 new weapons, blah, blah, blah. And it keeps going on and on.
Yeah. Why?
And all of the comments are kind of like saying this now. And I'm not saying one or two. There's like dozens of comments are coming in like this. And I'm like, I'm thinking to myself, what happened? I'm like, I think I know what happened.
Uh-oh. Some idiot. It's the idiots again. Idiot alert.
Someone, of course, probably.
Dunce alert.
Haters.
Actually, no, it's just some guy. I haven't heard of that guy before. I think he does like Elden Ring videos or something, but it's just some guy.
Probably posted up an out of context clip or reference to my podcast, basically maybe taking the one segment where I was speculating and saying, man, I hope it's worth $40 because it could be a ripoff. Maybe they're going to...
Well, he was... Yeah, he clipped the segment that he wanted to respond to. We're not going to have like a video where just so you can respond to Phil, you need to add like 45 minutes worth of context. Nobody's going to do that. The context is enough to see that you're speculating and fucking making a big deal out of stuff you know nothing about, and then you criticize other people for doing the same things you're doing. But when you do it, it's okay. That is what I think the whole point is.
Just overcharge for it because you've been waiting for so long and they know there's so much hype. Now, that was one tiny moment of speculation amongst a giant segment of my podcast that was incredibly positive about this DLC. But how much do you want to bet that's the clip that was taken? And likely they went to, like, for example, what do you call it? They probably went to, like, a Reddit or something, right? Like a fan Reddit or something like that and posted it up there. So basically, these are people who are, like, adamantly looking to defend their game against people who...
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Is it?
Okay.
Are they? Let's check out that guy's channel. Where do I find him? I lost it completely. Okay, let's look up the history. History. So, Josh Prime Gaming. Let's see what he does. Well, he does Elden Ring dropping tomorrow. DLC leak. You're not ready. Well, it looks like a guy who is hyped for it, but there's like 1,000 people. I can see why he would be hyped for it. Yeah, it's like an Elden Ring-based channel. So if you're doing something like this, somebody comes up with a shitty take, you're going to make a video about it, obviously. That makes sense. The only thing I mind is the clickbait, because the title is clickbait. I mean, come on. And it's made up as a quote. If it wasn't a quote, I would get it, but it's a quote, and it's made up. That's the only thing I got against it. But I agree with the guy in the video and his points.
Now, I'm not the biggest fanboy of Elden Ring. I'm a fan. I was very fair to the game when it came out. I had a ton of very positive things to say about it when it came out. I mean, it was my most played game of the year. Yes, I put more hours into Elden Ring in 2022 than any other game that year. Including
okay.
Multiplayer games. I still played Elden Ring more. All right.
So Oh my God. I hate this man's fucking brain, man.
My runner up for game of the year, but I did have some criticisms of it. I think I have the right to fairly criticize the game, and I feel like I did fairly criticize it when it came out. I really don't feel like I was overly unfair to it. I just thought that there was a lot of things that could have been improved. That's not the point of this video, so I don't need to list them here. You understand? You can watch my review of the game that I made in 2022 if you want to hear those. But basically, to me, like, I'm like, so what really happened, right? And exactly, Agent Coop says, you even started a second run. How could anyone say there's Elden Ring hate on this channel? But again, this is exactly...
Because, like, he's, oh my God, he's taking this whole thing completely backwards, and he's defending himself from stuff that doesn't exist. Because, like, he's acting like people attacked him because he hates Elden Ring. And his argument is to say how much he loves it. And it's like, that's not the whole point. That is not the point. The point is, you are yapping about stuff you know nothing about with full conviction, which is something that you criticize other people for doing, which makes you a hypocrite.
The situation.
But he doesn't, like, he's not, I don't know how to tell you. His brain is not developed enough to understand that that's it. He just sees it in, like, black and white terms. He sees it as like, oh, you love this or you hate this? And people criticizing me because I hate this, apparently, but I love this.
Situation I live in. You guys got to understand, especially those of you
who are
newcomers here, and you ask questions such as, why do so many people hate Darkseid Phil?
Why does Darkseid Phil snort so much? Why does Darkseid Phil ask for so much money, but at the same time earns a whole lot more than me? That's also a good question. Why does Darkseid Phil dress up like he's about to go and file for a divorce, but at the same time his backdrop is something that you would see in the playpen at McDonald's? A lot of questions.
This is why. Because completely out of my power, completely out of the realm of anything that I've done wrong or can control, people always misrepresent me
really?
In the eyes of the public. and they'll say that I did things I didn't do. They'll say I said things I didn't say.
Did he actually watch the video? I'm very curious. Did he actually watch the video? I don't think he did, to be honest.
They'll take things out of...
I think he just saw the comments and assumed what was in the video, which is, it sounds like a very big DSP thing. Sounds like something that happens to him a lot.
Context, right? They'll take rage moments from me playing a night of fighting games where twice I rage, and they'll say that was the whole stream.
No, that was just a highlight of the stream. You don't want to watch the whole stream. That's the point of clipping stuff.
Right? That's what they do. And so how do you combat that?
Because like, I'm not going to go watch a 30-minute segment of him playing a fighting game just so I can build up to the point where he calls somebody a mouth drooler and that they should die.
When, sadly, people on the internet are so willing to become like this big defense force for the games that they're massive fans of.
And what if you're wrong?
Do any research, because in reality,
wait, they don't do any research on you. But the whole thing is you not doing research on the game and you being ignorant. That's the whole topic. That's the whole idea. But now they don't do research. Actually, he hits you with the no you. Oh, Phil, you're ignorant. No, actually, you're ignorant of me. There you go. Take this. Take this, dunces.
The internet are so...
Take this, mouth droolers.
Like, big defense force for the games that they're massive fans of, and they don't do any research.
They don't do any research.
Reality, all these people that came to the video and watched it and attacked it in the comments, because the video now has like over 1,300 views. Just so you guys know, my podcast typically gets 300 to 500 views a day. That's it. If it's a more important day, maybe up to 1,000. This one, obviously...
What does more important mean?
It has... Big views by the
very market. Interesting. So, what is more important, when drama happens, when you got to respond to low tier god because he dissed you, when you got to beg for money because you were sick last week? Yes, that's what it means.
Someone posted it somewhere and people came over to attack it negatively, right? So where did this come from, right? I hate to say it, people on the internet are far too leaning towards being so into defending things they like.
Bro, that's what you did with Xbox. That's literally what you did. Day one, when the news came out, they're going multi-platform. Exactly what he did.
For no good reason, all right? You don't need to defend Elden Ring. Everyone knows it's good, right? I don't think anyone's gonna sit here and say, wow, Elden Ring is terrible. Who's gonna say that?
But nobody said that. Why are we even talking about this? This is straw man. Nobody said this. Not you said this. Nobody said you said this.
Yeah. It's objectively good. It may not be everyone's favorite game, but it's still objectively good. You don't need to go defend it, especially on a podcast like mine. You know, I don't get a ton of views. I'm not a popular
guy. Oh my
god.
Yeah, but you are a guy. And if you're a guy out there, you got to know at any point you can be clipped.
Misinformation and hate are two very different things.
Yep.
If this how he reacts to people's criticism of his game takes, I can't wait for people to criticize his awful policies and see how he reacts to that.
Oh yeah, it's gonna be like, man, like, it's fucking crazy. Because this video about Elden Ring is about as safe as you can get. It's not nothing crazy. He didn't go super toxic in it. He didn't call anybody any name. But imagine his response to like a fucking DSP segment, a DSP politics segment, where he just has a really shitty take that he thinks is super normal. Because this is also the guy who, like, he's on the fence about incest and says that having sex with your family is not cool because you grew up together. It's not meaningful enough. You need to have sex with people you don't know that good. That was the only thing stopping him.
Really listening to my opinions as a revelation,
like, actually
realized before, you know what I'm saying? So it doesn't even make much sense to me that this would be a big thing, and I don't understand why people fall for it either, because it's a trick is what it is. It's, oh, you fell into the black hole of hating on Dark Side Phil because someone tricked you into
oh my god
do because in truth
we fell into the black hole of hating Dark Side Phil. This is wild.
Things, again, the comments people were leaving on the podcast.
It's like, bro, if thousands of people have been telling you for years a specific thing, and you're the only person who's gonna, like, actually stand up for yourself, nobody else is backing you up, maybe they're just right, man. Maybe you just gotta consider they're right.
Podcast don't even make sense. They're acting like I don't like Elden Ring.
If you actually maybe you're the problem.
Podcast, you would know I do. I say right in the podcast, I'm doing a second run. Can't wait to get back into it. So many positives. Excited to jump back.
Bro, nobody said you don't like Elden Ring. Nobody actually said this.
How could you think I hate the game? Or I'm misrepresenting the game in a negative light on purpose for clickbait views? What clickbait views did I get? I don't even understand what they're talking about.
And again, he is responding to comments on the video. Not the video. Because he didn't watch the video. I guarantee you that. At this point, I'm convinced he didn't see it.
But the thing that really kills
me... like, imagine defending yourself for 20 minutes from something that you didn't even watch.
Kills me. Okay? Is a lot of the things that people reference to say, oh, you were wrong, is information that wasn't publicly available when I did my podcast on Wednesday. Right now, it's 11:26 a.m. This podcast starts between 11:10 a.m. At 11:10 a.m. on Wednesday, the 21st of February, none of the information about this DLC that people are using to reference and say, oh, you're wrong, was available.
Epic. This is an epic point. That's what I was waiting for. Because like I mentioned before, this is the same guy who lost his shit when people started speculating about Xbox going multi-platform, when the rumor first started. And he shit on those people so hard just because they were wondering, they were curious about what was going to happen if Xbox decided to port the different games onto various systems. And he went crazy about it. But now when it happens to him and he's talking about the fucking something that he didn't know something about because he jumped the gun, now it's bad and he is a victim. You should feel bad for him.
No one knew.
Dude, I'm just a small guy. I get like 200 views.
It was 60 gigabytes in size. No one knew the map would be the size of Limgrave from the original game. No one knew there were 10 bosses.
Oh yeah, the same thing with Starfield. That's a good point, Metal Force. Because before Starfield came out, he said, Baldur's Gate 3 would never win Game of the Year. Even if Starfield is terrible, it's going to win Game of the Year and it's going to beat Baldur's Gate 3. Well, guess what happened? The opposite. And then he got called out, and this was exactly the defense he had.
No one.
Well, fucking idiot, I said that actually maybe.
Fly in the wall to hear him complaining to Cat about all of this. Do you think it sounds almost exactly like this, or more toxic and unhinged?
I think it's more toxic. I think they let the slurs fly in the Burnell household. I think they both just throw it up all over the place. And not that I mind, I also wish I was a fly at the wall. Damn, I wish I was fucking living in his walls so I can see everything happening. I'm so fascinated by what happens to him when he's not streaming. And I say there's like 90% chance that it's boring as fuck and all he does is just sit on the couch and play on his phone. But it would be interesting to witness.
Knew there were 8 new weapons. No one knew anything. This came out in an interview with Miyazaki later in the day. I think it was IGN, but don't quote me on that. I think it was. But it came out and then it's like, wow, this is all awesome. Positive information about the DLC, and it literally answers all the questions that we had about it. So now I'm even more sold on this DLC. If you're telling me it's going to be a minimum of the size of Limgrave, oh, by the way, this is what sells it for me. Miyazaki outright said in the interview, this has tons of legacy dungeons. The major focus of the DLC is legacy dungeons. Like, that's what they worked on. Now, what was my favorite part of Elden Ring? The legacy dungeons. I wasn't really having too much fun in the open world. I felt the open world after, you know.
Okay, bro, we're not asking you for this. We're not asking you for your review of Elden Ring, man. Because this whole clip is 20 minutes long. And 15 of those were just him talking about how much he loves Elden Ring. And that's his argument. Like, you can't tell me that I hate the game and I misrepresented because I like the game. You idiots.
And what's the name of the magical area? I've already forgotten. And of course, I did like the capital city. But after you get through those areas, right? I felt like it was just kind of too redone, especially that whole final third of the game in the frozen area, the land of the giants. I didn't like that at all, okay? My favorite part was going into a dungeon that felt like it was Dark Souls or Bloodborne. Those were my favorite parts. They were hand curated by the developers of the game to be interesting, challenging experiences. I loved those. Give me more legacy dungeons, give me less open world, and give me less of the very randomly generated boring dungeons, right? They're not randomly generated, but they're ones that are very repetitive and boring.
Yeah, bro, yeah.
Okay, I'm interested, but I wonder what it's going to be to, wow, now I'm actually really excited. Okay.
Okay. Well, but now again, he loves it.
Why are people coming to my podcast telling me I'm misrepresenting the game? I'm hating on the game. This is a hot take for click.
Bro, I don't know what the fucking people in the comments are saying. People in the comments say the weirdest shit. Go respond to the video, not some random dudes whose comments you can't even find because he didn't approve them. Like, why are we doing this?
Bait views and leaving dozens of negative comments, voting the
video. Because, like, he doesn't realize how bad of an argument this is, right? We can't even see who he's responding to. He might as well be just making up people that he's responding to just so he can seem right. Like, it's just not a good way to defend yourself.
Video down, and I'm like, what is happening? You tell me. It's nonsense, all right? And at least I'm happy now that we could talk about it today and actually talk about more of the positives about the DLC because I'm excited for it. But why does it have to be the result of a bunch of people coming and crapping all over me? Because you know what it is? Now there's another 5,000 people who hate me on the internet.
And now he thinks that those people are just... They're just watching my stuff now. They got addicted. They're watching Duty and my stuff and TBS. And Detractor Beam 24/7. Just because he said something they didn't agree with on Elden Ring. Look at this dude.
Right? They outright think I'm a jerk.
Well, you are a jerk.
I crapped all over Elden Ring.
Not just because.
I didn't even bother to watch my podcast and see what I said. Someone told them I said it, linked it, and they just went right to the video and left the next.
But no, they watched. Oh my God. Again, he hasn't seen the video. There's the clips of him that the guy is responding to.
He comment.
Like, literally.
What kind of a mentality is that? What kind of a person can you be?
But wait, did he even acknowledge that we're talking about a video that somebody made about him here? Or he's just responding to the comments and wondering where the comments came from? Like, actually, he was so fucking lazy. He was that lazy.
To judge someone.
Not even look up.
You've even said what.
But we immediately jump into a 20-minute self-defense segment. They put him in a self-defense situation. Now he got to pull up the Glock.
They've said. You didn't even bother to click play to see what was said in the podcast because there's no way you could watch that segment and come out of the other side of that podcast thinking that I hate Elden Ring and I'm crapping all over it for clickbait. It was not even present in the video.
And I'm sure the whole thing about hating Elden Ring and crapping on it for clickbait was just one guy. And it was the most... Like, the craziest comment he got, so he's clinging on that one.
At all, right? So anyway, I got it out of the way. Listen, I'm excited for the Elden Ring DLC. Really, I like all the additional information. 10 new bosses, that's a ton. 8 new weapons. I'm sure in those 8 weapons, there'll be one or two I want to try, so I might respec during the DLC and try them. That's awesome. Legacy dungeons are right up my alley. And if you remember Limgrave, that's the starting area of Elden Ring. That's the main area. There's 2 southern island areas to it that are...
Oh my God, I want to send you to that area, man. Shut the fuck up about this.
I now feel like... I now really feel like we're going to be in a situation where this is a feature of the year. Coming back to Elden Ring in May to join me for that fun later.
And now we're just hyping it up. Oh my God. Epic DSP segment. Self-defense, straw man, misrepresentation, ignorance, and then in the end, we just plug it for some hype.
Yeah, you guys, I hope you check out my stream.
In the year, all right? But as for these people who are misinformed, all I can say is...
They are misinformed, by the way. Please, you do more research. You. Yes, you. Before calling me out for being ignorant, you be less ignorant. It's insane, man. I cannot believe this shit. This was, yep, I showed you this already. And then what else? Oh yeah, we got the fucking suggestion box from yesterday. That shit was agonizing. Let me see what we can come up with on this. Suggestion box. I'll just look up his thing. How was that called? DSP Gaming. I legit forgot what his channel was. We got more questing and chill. So he's playing... Wow, he's playing Tekken 8 and Yakuza today. Man, he's just playing the same games over and over again. This shit is fucking boring. If you're not into these games, you're just gonna be gone from his streams for like weeks at a time. It fucking blows my mind how he thinks he can still be a full-time Let's Player in 2024 and not do anything else that involves any kind of editing or pacing. It's all just the worst. It's the worst. So this is it. At 100 hours in, updated thoughts on Baldur's Gate. I'm skipping this. Level 1 podcast. I'm skipping this. So let's find the Boon Cuck and look at his super professional timestamps. So this is it, blah, blah, blah. Oh, this is really interesting. Hold on. And this is 20 likes on this comment. Let's see this one. You really need to learn to engage in healthy discussion, man. For someone who has had so much to say about everything, you're way too quick to dismiss any sort of debate as someone being a fanboy or part of the defense force. This is already an incredible comment, because that's exactly what he does, and he's been doing it always. Always. 20 plus years of hate. So many things you say about Final Fantasy 16 are factually untrue, but you pass it off as fact just because you don't like it. Big shock. All while ignoring counterpoints in the chat. That's not a good look. It's definitely not a perfect game and it has flaws, but the pacing and side quests are not one of them. Clapped. I even wonder why this got approved. Why? I'm sure if I left this comment, it wouldn't. I don't know. Oh, because it's Onso Kamaru. There we go. It's a cuck. There we go. It's a cuck. That's the only reason. And it's a top comment, of course. It's the only comment that got more than one like on it. Literally. And it's got 20 of them. So fantastic. Let's look at the Boon Cuck and what has been going on. So progress update, challenges in Tekken 8. We do not care. So look at the pacing of this podcast. Since we got a breakdown here from the Cuck, let's look at how this podcast is paced. So from the second minute, we start talking about Baldur's Gate 3. And he recaps the whole progress. And then he does a schedule, apparently, but not really. Then we do a review of the positive and negatives about Baldur's Gate 3. Then at 10 minutes, we're still talking about the plot developments and decision-making in Baldur's Gate 3. So this is straight up 10 minutes of just bullshit. If you don't care about this, you might as well just go outside and walk your dog. Progress update and challenges in Tekken 8. By the way, the Baldur's Gate 3 segment is like 15 minutes. Progress update and challenges. So this takes only 6 minutes, which I'm very fascinated by. I remember when he used to play Street Fighter 6, and every day he would read out his statistics and his win-loss rate, and it was the worst thing you've ever seen. It's actually the worst. Upcoming schedule. So literally, 23 minutes is worthless scheduling and recap. So far. So basically everything. Basically everything. Then we got another review of Baldur's Gate 3. Quote-unquote review. Another one. Another segment. Then we got accessibility talk, Baldur's Gate 3. Immersive experience, Baldur's Gate 3. Meaningful character progression and rewarding leveling system, Baldur's Gate 3. It's like 40 minutes of Baldur's Gate 3, the game he hasn't finished yet. Then we got critique. Then we got reflections. Then we got overall assessment. We're passing the 1 hour point at this point. Handling mailed items. Oh, so this is somebody send him something.
Quiet Sparrow for a membership this morning.
Of course they did.
It's a legit first-time membership, so thank you for that. Brendan, thank you for re-upping your membership for a second month. Dakaze did a super chat and says, do you have any kind of a public mailing address that you check? Because I'd love to share something with you. No. And I've already said this out many times publicly. Please do not send me stuff.
Except the people that he gets approved. And this dude is so fucking pretentious that you have to tell him what you're gonna send him. And if he doesn't like it, you don't send it. That's how fan mail works for him. You don't send it. If he doesn't want it, he doesn't like it. Nope. You only send him good stuff.
Without running it by me first.
Because this is how much of a choosing beggar he is.
To get permission to do so. Because sadly, I hate to say it, I just get too much harassment in life in general, not just on the internet, everywhere. Harassment. And there have been people over the years that just send me stuff. You know, I hate to say it, there's some people out there who have really nasty, bad, harmful intentions. So now if I get something in the mail and I don't know what it is and I don't recognize it, it goes right in the trash. And I guarantee you there's been people who've sent me stuff over the years that was legitimately good, but they didn't tell me up front. I have to throw it out. I have to do it for the safety of my family.
For the safety of my family? Does he think somebody's gonna mail him a nail bomb? What does he think is gonna happen? Does he think there's gonna be anthrax inside it? That you can easily trace back to whoever the fuck sent it? Are you serious? He's acting like there's legitimately people trying to kill him. How much of an over-exaggeration is this?
The fucked up stuff that's happened. So, no, I don't just accept stuff being mailed to me.
Come on, man. And I get it. Somebody might send him like a bag of shit. Or I actually think they have sent him that before. Somebody sent him a cardboard dick. It's like, also, yeah, you can send him some trash. You can send him some, like, jokes and memes. But, like, putting his family at risk? That's just drama. That's just drama.
That. If you're interested in possibly reaching out to me for something that you want to mail, contact me via email. Let's
Hey, talk. Phil, I want to mail you a spoon so you can eat shit out of my fucking ass. Oh, goddamn, that segment was something else. Then we got viewer contributions and stream goals. Gameplay, where's the suggestion box? Huh? Oh, so I guess it's this one. Oh, there we go. I guess the OP cook has the stamps for that one as well. So yeah, blah, blah, blah. This is worthless. This is worthless. Okay, this is what we want. We got suggestion box somewhere here, I guess. Viewer feedback and suggestions. Oh, this is it. Okay, let's go.
I'd like to do today, because we have a little bit of extra time, we're going to do a little bit of suggestion.
Oh my god, his fucking tits look like they're getting bigger by the day, man. Stop wearing these shirts. They're making your boobs fucking distracting. Why are they so big? Legit.
Suggestions thread that has now been live for about a little over a week.
£5 from Comrade Alex. Finally caught you live. Just want to say his arrogance and unlove is absolutely kitten astounding. I just don't know how he functions.
Yeah, man. Because for catching me live for the first time, dude. Welcome, Alex. But the fucking... especially in like segments like this, where I can't.
And I'm going to...
This is the worst.
Pull up some suggestions from said thread. Okay. So last time around, I was at... Okay. Let me refresh now. Actually, I don't need to refresh. I could just keep going from here. Crap. Now I lost my spot. Here it is.
Come on, dude.
Would you consider, you can't even okay, get we're started. Do suggestion box. Ready?
All right. First
Would
one. Let's go.
We're going to Call of Duty to add to variety maybe once every few weeks for a night stream.
Why?
We were going to do that. And what happened was...
okay, this one gets skipped.
Remember, we were going to do it during my Super Bowl event. I think, I'll be honest, I like Call of Duty. I think it's silly fun. I don't take it seriously, but when I play it, I go ham with dual handguns and stuff. I like that, but I just think, like, the appeal of Call of Duty has died out. You know what I mean? Like, it's cool for, like, a month, and people are, like, tired of it. Because it's the same thing. I mean, let's be honest. Call of Duty has not innovated in many, many years. They don't even try anymore. So, I get it. So what I should do is just randomly turn the stream on and off every day. And if you know it's happening, great. And if not, oh well.
Hold on, what? Why did he have to get so passive-aggressive? What was the context of this?
I'm going to be playing a ton of Final Fantasy VII. How I just told you the schedule is changing. And I'm probably going to add in Retro React every week moving forward. But we're going to have other nights off for taxes. All this stuff that I'm telling
you. Oh, the tax nights. Oh my god, it's tax season.
You need to know. I shouldn't tell you.
Okay, so yes. This is about the... How did this happen so fast?
It's cool for like a month.
I just skipped the whole fucking Call of Duty thing, and now he's just bitching about the podcast.
The rotation, and then people are like, meh, they'd rather much see other things. So, yeah, I don't think Call of Duty is coming back. Stop going over the schedule every day and recap what you did the previous day. It's boring, pointless, and filler.
Literally, these are the most suggestions. But now, not only is he going to be passive-aggressive, he's going to be super condescending, too. Because he knows better than you, the person who's being asked for advice.
So you're telling me right now, as I'm explaining to all of you, how I'm going to be playing a ton of Final Fantasy VII, how I just told you the schedule is changing, and I'm probably going to add in Retro React every week moving forward, but we're going to have other nights off for taxes. All this stuff that I'm telling you that's very important, that you need to know, I shouldn't tell you.
No, you can just say it in the daily wrap. All this shit takes like 30 seconds to say. To say, hey, on Friday, I'm going to be streaming Final Fantasy. That's it. That's all you got to do.
So what I should do is just randomly turn the stream on and off every day.
And of course. Now we gotta act like it's such a crazy, insane thing to ask of him that we're jumping to the extremes. Yeah, I'm gonna turn the stream on and off. I'm not even gonna have a title for the stream. You're never even gonna know what I'm streaming. Because, well, I can't do the schedule anymore, so there is no schedule.
And if you know it's happening, great. And if not, oh well. So basically, you want me to be like Wings of Redemption. No, I'm not going to be like Wings of Redemption. And I'm not going to be like other streamers who don't plan, don't focus, don't be, they're not transparent with their audience. I'm not everybody else.
Uh-huh.
If you want to watch everybody else, you can go watch everyone else.
Yeah, that's what they did. If I were you, I would stop telling people to go watch somebody else because they actually will, and they actually have. That's why you can barely get like 300 viewers.
Who isn't meticulous about planning and being transparent and explaining what they're going to do.
Is meticulous.
You just go do that. And
no, it's just the thing is, it's really none of my business why he's going to play a specific game on a particular day. It really isn't. So I don't want to have to listen to 20 minutes of it.
And be upset when they're not streaming.
Like, he doesn't even start to begin to think about comprehending how insane of an idea it is for you to have a lengthy segment recapping the previous stream you did and going over your entire weekly schedule every single day. He cannot fathom how that can be bad.
They said they were going to do, where are they?
That's actually, not only this, we go even further. It's actually a great thing that he is doing it, and you're just not getting it right. You're just the guy who's misunderstanding him in the purpose of this existing. You complaining? That's your problem.
I don't get it. What are they doing?
You're demanding too much.
Hey, no one knows. Are they even streaming today? I don't know. Go watch them. Have fun. No one's stopping you. But if you want actual something that's treated professionally, seriously... And I'm on really? Time and I work my butt off every day.
Really?
That's what you're here for, right?
Oh, by the way, I've been trying to cut together an edit of his rant towards LTG. But something that is very interesting in it is that whenever he wants to snort and clear his throat, he actually went out of his way to mute himself. That's something interesting that I noticed. So when he knows people are watching on purpose, there is no throat clears, there is no snorts, and if there have to be some, we get muted. That has something to tell you about Phil.
So if you don't like that, don't come by to watch the content that's well-planned, and I explain to you in the
well-planned
change.
Content.
A lot of the times, all right?
The well-planned content, such as special event marathon streams that consist of playing a video game, watching the AI play a video game, and eating perhaps a burger or a sandwich. That is the well-planned, intelligent, sophisticated, business degree acquired, detoxified, wholesome, and based content.
The reason why I do the schedule on the streams is very simple, to get immediate feedback. I can start today. I already found out. I said, gee, you know, if we did a...
Well, that doesn't seem like it works because you ask for the same type of feedback every single day and you can't get it, so the suggestion box needs to exist. So no, it doesn't really work.
React next week, what should we do? And immediately people are like, how about Batman Arkham City? How about Bioshock? So I'm getting the feedback I need. If I just do this stuff without any immediate feedback, I'm just talking to a wall. You know, I don't know what people would like. I want opinions.
No, none of this makes any sense.
To improve.
No,
right?
No. You don't do it. That's the thing. You don't do it.
That's how you actually do well in this kind of a landscape.
Oh, are you doing well, Phil?
Versus just making decisions for yourself. You know what I'm saying?
No, you make decisions for your business, not for yourself personally. And thinking about that, he makes many decisions for his business that are specifically for himself.
He's never on time. He always late, always.
Yeah, pretty much. Unless there's some like mega drama. But actually is the opposite. If there is insane drama, he's going to let the music play for extra long so you can be held in anticipation. And then he's going to save up the drama for the last like 20 minutes of the stream. Then he's going to have the segment on the drama. And after that, he's going to do shout-outs, which more often than not have something to say about the drama. So he's going to continue the drama. That's a very good way to pace a DSP stream.
But I don't understand why people don't understand that. Like,
big ups, Copeside Phil.
But it serves a humongous purpose and has been a boon. By the way, I should say this again. There are tons of people who tune into my streams just for the podcast. And... they have a lot of fun.
And of course, now we are misinterpreting the criticism as the podcast is bad and it shouldn't exist. It's like, bro, he just doesn't understand that there's just segments of the podcast that are dog shit and they shouldn't exist.
On the podcast.
And of course, my customers, they're just happy, dude. They're just happy. They show up just for the sandwich.
go over this.
The shit sandwich, and they love it. It's delicious. Stuff
because they feel like they're...
They say, Mr. Brunel, your sandwich is so good.
Part of it. They feel like they can impact it. In fact, they can impact it by just being there and talking in the chat right now. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, and you can call him a moron.
Okay.
Very nice.
All right, let's continue on. I will not be surprised if you ignore this post. Well, does it sound like I'm ignoring it? I'm reading it right now. Number one, you made chat an integral part of your gameplay so much...
Oh, yeah. So this is the An Lead post. He posted it on the Sock account.
The sense of exploration or adventure when you touch a new title...
So he is literally responding to a troll. And he doesn't even know.
...is evaporated.
Hell!
You rely on your chat for more innocuous decisions and solutions, you abandon...
Oh, and look at how he's tapping with the leg. He's super worked up over this shit.
...enjoyment and watching a streamer discovering a mechanic or overcoming a hurdle. Consider the rule you have about spoilers from your own chat rules and actually applying it. When it's okay to ask for chat's input from time to time, you have become more aware. You straddle the line for aid to over-reliance. So basically what you're saying is you don't like the Baldur's Gate 3 playthrough.
Oh my god! Dude, I'm gonna kill him.
$5 from Kopsai Defal. You don't need to talk about your schedule 3 times in an hour and a half podcast, and you don't need to recap what happened the previous day every day.
So what you're telling me is that you don't like the podcast, and you want me to delete and never have a podcast ever again. Okay. Okay, well, all I gotta tell you is that people show up for the podcast and they enjoy it, so your feedback is invalid. Next time, send me positive feedback, invalid feedback. You dunce.
Because that's what this is. This doesn't apply to literally any other playthrough.
No, it does.
It only applies to the Baldur's Gate 3 playthrough.
Oh my god. He's so annoying. He is so annoying, man.
Every playthrough that I do, everybody knows it's in the rules. You are not to outright spoil. You are not to tell me what to do. You're not going to do plot points. You're not going to do combat. But I have to figure it out for myself.
Oh my god, he's the worst.
I feel like I'm stuck.
It's the worst. I hate it so much. This segment is so bad, man. It's getting under my skin.
I'm not understanding. Then I will turn the chat and we'll talk about it, right? But it has to be with my blessing or permission.
People with his blessing.
Get banned. It's against the rules. It always has been. The one exception has been Baldur's Gate 3 because since...
No, it's not. I've literally heard him in the past say that he's going to drop the controller until people in chat tell him what to do. And I might be able to find it on here. I don't remember exactly what the quote was. So let's see, DSP leaves the controller or something. One of his worst meltdowns, the worst player in video game history. So Asmongold reacted to him again. This was the Zelda clip. Which one was it? Oh, it's Resident Evil 3? Oh, it's the thing, the puzzle boss at the end on the, what was it called? Some kind of a bell tower or something. Okay, let's try looking up this and looking it up in the transcript because I want to find it. I'm petty as fuck. Oh, there isn't any controller here. Or is it? No, there isn't.
$5 from JE5150. It has to be with his blessing like he's some mafia don.
Yeah, it does sound like it. Nothing happens without my blessing. It does really sound like it. He's the mafioso. Because, I mean, of course, he's Italian. So, okay, I'm going to try and find it. But until then, let's listen to his suggestion box.
Day one with the Baldur's Gate 3 playthrough, it has been, I don't understand this universe. I don't play D&D, so I don't get the lore. I don't understand dice rolls. I certainly don't understand the meticulous rule set of the combat of Baldur's Gate 3. This is all new to me, right? Imagine if you were walking into a building and everything was written in Greek, right? Now you kind of know what the building is for, but you can't read anything because it's all written in Greek. So do you just stand there trying to figure out the Greek for yourself with a book trying to translate on the fly? Or do you have someone who's a Greek translator come in with you to tell you what everything is so you can efficiently do things in the building? Which would you prefer? Translating with a book for yourself or having the translator help you? That's essentially what the chat is right now for Baldur's Gate 3. They're translating.
But dog, hold on. Dude, the game tells you the stuff. They explain it to you. And you, if you wanted to, you could just figure it out on yourself. This is just you refusing to learn. This has nothing to do with fucking Greek.
Very foreign game. into a language I can understand. For the most part, all right, I am getting it. And in fact, take a look at the last couple of streams.
Oh my God. No, no. Go fuck yourself. Go fuck yourself. I'm not sitting through this part because I know exactly what it's going to be.
So take a look at the last few streams. So I went to this level and then I figured out how to do it. And then I passed all the quests and I did it myself. So you're a dunce.
That isn't, it's fallible. It's false.
Oh, but let's see him calling the argument false.
People say, okay, so here's what you're going to do. You're going to go through that door. You're going to head right. There's an enemy there hiding. Don't get hit by that enemy. Then dodge left and right. None of that happens.
Yeah, that's exactly what happens.
You're an
though.
Idiot.
You're an idiot. Just straight, dude.
You're a liar. All right? What you're trying to do is you're trying to create a straw man.
Oh my God. What? Dude. Somebody's going to call the cops on me in my fucking apartment building, dude. I cannot. Holy shit. Holy shit. I'm so pissed off. How do you piss me off so much, man? Because this is like the ultimate DSP segment. You tell him something in the most detailed way as if he's an actual fucking retard. You treat him like a baby. You explain the issue exactly how it's supposed to be. And not only are you wrong, you do the thing that he is doing. He's projecting on you what he's doing. He's projecting on you that you're an idiot and you're trying to create a straw man while he is creating a fucking straw man.
And then you present that straw man.
And he's just straight up insulting you in the end.
As a fact, it's not a fact. It's the straw man you created to present an argument that isn't, it's fallible.
Oh
it's
my false. God.
It's a false narrative, okay? If you don't like Baldur's Gate 3 playthrough because of the way I've done it, don't watch it. Play it yourself. And don't try to generalize comments like this because it just makes you look stupid.
Uh-huh. Okay? Sure. Why was that the top comment on the thread, though? Tell me why. Is it because the trolls like it? Well, I guess so.
Cool.
Cool. Oh, my God. This guy is incredibly insufferable. And it's going to bite him in the ass eventually because this is the same fucking behavior he has towards his own fan base.
Yeah, you're trying to give me actual advice, actual constructive feedback, and you break it down so I can understand how it works like I'm a fucking retard? No, you're a fucking idiot, and you're stupid, and you're biased.
Just listen to this. I love this. Because this guy, every comment this guy leaves is angry, right? Really? Every comment. A literal, like an angry butthurt comment.
You're the one who's insulting him. I don't know how that was butthurt.
Right?
Okay, let's hear it.
Follow your rules regarding bullying and harassing in your chat. Because apparently I just let people bully and harass others all day long in my chat.
You actually do, yeah. I can go harass Derek on a daily basis. I mean, you got fucking Canadian Kirk who's been banned by YouTube. Not even banned from DSP's chat. And he's still around to still allowed to sit around because he keeps sending him $10 tips every once in a while.
Do you see? This is...
$5 from Poxwalker. I can't wait for him to do these tactics with his political takes.
Oh man, he's gonna... But that's the thing. That's the thing with him. You can fucking curb stomp him every day.
The amount of delusion Phil has...
You can break down every single frame of every single video he's ever done and point out scientifically, using a fucking textbook, every time he's been wrong and exactly why he's been wrong, he would never accept it. It just wouldn't happen. So you would be ending up like bashing your head into a wall. It's like playing chess with a chicken. The chicken is just eventually going to jump on top of the board and kick all the pieces around and think that it's won. God damn it, this dude.
The classic case of a loaded questions or loaded suggestions, they're proposing scenarios that don't exist as if they do to then say, well, here's a criticism, but your criticism is invalid. Do I allow people to come into my chat and bully and harass others all day long? No.
Yes, but they do. You might not allow it, but they get away with it.
Lots of other streamers do.
What about Derek? Because this is the guy who I've heard him 1,000 times say that he's worked up over people bullying Derek. So let's look it up. DSP Gaming Derek. Derish. And let's see what we got on Derish. Here it is. Well, here it is. And this one is like 8 minutes long. We got another one. So here we got DSP rages while defending Derek over the new taco meme because he asked the girl if her pussy tastes like Trader Joe tacos. Unironically, that's legitimately it. Then we got DSP dedicates another segment defending his son Derek. So here we got another one. Then Derek, oh, this is a very good example as well. Derek submits a video and people just clown on him. So this is just the chat reaction. Some cringe ass weird video and just people clowning on him immediately. Yep. Here's the actual video if you're asking for a link. Okay, anyways, back to this.
People actually say the opposite of my chat. That is not allowed, right? And a lot of people complain about that. They say, oh, man, you know, Phil, you know, he doesn't allow that stuff. So now we don't have freedom to say what we want or something, right? But it's true. The truth is people have a good time in the chat because they don't have to worry about a lot of people attacking each other. They don't have to worry about people being bullying and nasty to each other. Does it happen sometimes? Yes. I can't always stop it. You see when I call it out. Absolutely. You see me call it out and stop that shit and put an end to it, right? But there you go, right?
Yeah, and apparently this is like a negative, toxic, insulting comment, even though it was put very, very eloquently. And I'm not just saying this because it's Ann Leet and I like the guy. I'm just saying it because it is like that.
I'm not even going to read another word from this guy. Do you want to know what he said in this comment? He says there's cases of erotic role
play. Rodrigo Marquez. On that clip you showed, Phil immediately starts swinging the ban hammer to protect Derich.
Yeah.
His own wife doesn't get this treatment.
Actually, yes. She doesn't get the treatment. And, well, I guess kind of she does, because he eradicates a lot of the memes about her, but some of them he doesn't even know. Doesn't like, even acknowledge the memes.
Active discourse. Why am I even reading this? Do you see? He actually said that.
We have to find something to dismiss. No, they've unironically been like sexual roleplay in his chat.
Listen
before.
To this. He says.
And I'm sure Ann Leet can find it. That's the thing. I'm sure he can find it. But even if magically they were to meet and Ann Leet would show this to DSP like face to face, the most convincing evidence ever, he would still not accept it. That's why you should never try and help this guy out. Never. Because he will never get better. He's never going to improve. It's all fucking charades. It's all a theater. Just so you can pay his fucking bills. That's all that it comes down to. It's not about fucking gaming. It's not about chilling. It's not about interacting or Q&A or about fucking content. He's willing to say anything to protect his own ego and get his bills paid.
There is a lack of moderation. There's a cultivation of a community of bullies and harassers, of legitimate viewers and active fans. It's a combination of spam trolling and erotic roleplay permeating the active discourse of my chat. It's obvious the reason the person said up front, you're not going to post this comment, is because they wanted me to read the most ridiculous things I've ever seen, right? Let me tell you guys, at every moment, it's just erotic roleplay in my chat. I mean, that's the problem. It's a major...
And of course, his debunk is to take it to the extreme and say that, it's always like that. Of course, the most DSP thing.
Problem. I've been reported so many times for it, uh-huh. It's completely out of control.
There you go. Epic. Well, sure.
Right? I mean, totally. That's not the polar opposite of the truth. And, you know, and people don't give me shit all the time for not making sexual comments and not partaking in any kind of romantic relationships and games. It's that we're just constantly doing erotic roleplay.
Yes, constantly, gotcha. Yes.
Right. I've had enough of reading that comment.
And that's why sometimes, like, when I see him be this fucking delusional, sometimes I would see somebody just blatantly lying about him, and I wouldn't fucking mind. I wouldn't fucking mind. Because he's the guy lying about himself. Everything about him is a fucking lie. It's fraud. It's a theater. It's a mask.
Move on to another one.
So why is he the only guy who's allowed to lie about himself?
That was a complete waste of time. Good Lord. Oh, let's see. By the way, that guy, no kidding, he had like 10 bullet points in his comment.
Okay. Is that supposed to be bad? That he took the time and effort to give you criticism? It actually should mean a lot more that he's a troll, a person who actively does not like you and does not think you're a good person. And he took the time and effort to put together a list of elaborately explained bullet points that make sense and are factually based. But sure, I guess that sucks now.
10 things he actually expected.
But I thought you love fucking feedback. What happened with that?
To me to go through when the first two were so ludicrous.
Of course.
Okay. Let's go. Okay.
And of course the fakest laugh. Man, I need a fucking cigarette after this shit.
Well, the chat is responding pretty appropriately to that comment. Okay.
What are they saying?
I've been a fan of yours since Heavy Rain. Ugh, I hair in my mouth. Ugh. Okay. I get why you had to change from how you used to be. Nowadays, I do find you kind of boring. I mean, put me to sleep boring. I haven't been able to watch any videos since Hades. I try, but somehow you need to figure out how to become more entertaining. Well, here's the thing. There's different kinds of content. There's different kinds of entertainment. All right? Sure, 10, 15 years ago, I was known as the over-the-top.
Oh, my God. No. No. In case you didn't fucking think this segment could get worse, it just did.
Equal opportunity offender. Like,
no, he's not an equal opportunity offender. He's a guy who wanted to seem way more interesting than what he actually was. Because he was a boring fucking person. With no life experiences and no charisma and no character. So he's just was making racist jokes. And the jokes is very... It's a very strong word for it. It's just, I guess, racism is how you would call it.
That's what I called myself.
No, he had nothing better to say, so he said the things that are going to get people looking his way and talking about him.
I'm the equal opportunity.
That's it.
I will.
He wasn't anything equal opportunity. He's not fucking Howard Stern. He's not fucking Larry David. He's not even Brendan Schaub. He's dark side fucking Phil.
Criticize and make jokes about any race, any creed, any gender. It'll be about sex. It'll be about violence. It'll be about...
No, it would be about the main stereotype that is associated with that race. So when he sees a black guy, he's going to say something about him having a gun or playing basketball. When he sees an Asian guy, he's going to say something about him eating pork fried rice or talking in a strange way that he can't understand. When he talks about a Mexican person, he's going to talk about him doing fucking backyard work and shit like that. It was literally the most commonly associated stereotype for any kind of race or culture you can think about. He's just looking about it and saying, hey, this is a person. This is the stereotype that they have. There is no humor to this. There is no joke to this. It's not funny. It's not interesting. Don't get me wrong. It absolutely can be. It can. You can make a fucking hilarious joke out of it. He just didn't.
You know, ethnicity, as long as they're generalized jokes. That's the thing. I never wanted to... make it so that a certain group
big up Sigmoid for the 2 months, dude,
felt like they were being targeted. And I don't think I ever really received a complaint about that. Normally it would be that, yes, by the time
and big ups for the 5 gifts
for a joke, some people would be like, oh man, it's hard to take. But then again, Phil kind of jokes about everything.
Uh-huh.
So it's kind of fair.
No,
right?
No, they didn't say that. They just didn't want to speak out because people generally liked him back in the day when he initially started. People had a decent opinion of him. So they didn't want to speak out because they're going to get dogpiled on in the comments.
Back in the day, no one complained. No one had issue with that commentary, all right? Now they do. Now anything like that is considered an absolutely horrible joke. Anytime
no, it's
I
not.
Try to make a dark joke these days, people criticize. I mean, take a look.
Yeah, because they're not funny. They're just stupid.
At the playthrough that I did, I don't even remember the name of the game anymore.
Oh, right? the Prepare the Slave Trade.
It was the game about... the heist went wrong, right? That there were like 3 brothers who were doing a heist at like a gas station, and there's other survivors in there, and basically there's a girl and there's a corrupt sheriff. So I made a joke in the playthrough, all right, that the corrupt sheriff, who by the way, there's evidence in the game, he has a black book of horrible things he's done to the town. He's basically blackmailing the town. He's a drug dealer. He's a scumbag. So I make a dark joke that this guy also maybe like taking in kids and having like a whole kind of slave trade deal going on too, because that's the kind of thing a guy like that would do. If this guy really was ruling the town with an iron fist and he's like this underworld kingpin, but he's the sheriff too, don't you think he would be doing more awful things? So I make the comment and people, oh, horrible joke. Awful. Don't you see how that joke's terrible? What an awful thing to say. And I'm like, that's literally the kind of joke I made every 5 seconds. Back in the day in my old commentary.
There we go. This is the point. This is the entire point, because this dude that jerked himself dry over how much he has changed and how much of an amazing person he is nowadays does the same shit he used to do back in the day when he was a terrible fucking person. There you go. Case closed.
That's a mild joke compared to the kind of jokes that I used to make back in the day. It really, really is. So the fact that today you can't even make
from down forward punch,
dark jokes
back like that, he should become a rainbow
because you'll be, you know what I'm saying?
Begs account.
People are, oh my God, a dark joke. They can't take it, right? So that's why in the modern era, you can't be like that anymore. You just can't. You can be.
Hold on. I was gone for a second. Let me just refresh this pop-up. Sorry about that.
$5 from down forward punch. With a rack like that, he should become a love streamer and create an OnlyBegs account.
Dude, I mean, this rack is fucking nasty. I don't want to look at it. I don't want it to exist. It's just weirdly distracting. It's like somebody having a strange zit or a wart on their face.
Gained 666. And remember, he said the teenagers like this.
Yeah, and he would even call them kids as well. The children like racism, dude. They love it.
If you constantly want to be the subject of a drama discourse, like if you're doing it today, you obviously are not a serious creator. All you're trying to do is get people to talk about you in a negative light, so at least your name's...
Phil, you're not a serious creator. Look at your layout. Nothing serious about that. Look at your background. Look at your clothes. Your tits hanging out. You're not a serious creator. You're not even a creator. You're a generator. You're a producer.
...out there. And that's not my goal. I literally could today go right back to that style of commentary. And if I did, I would be talked about all over the internet. Oh my God, did you hear Dark Side Film went back?
No,
to this
not really.
Commentary, it's over the top.
Not really. Not really, actually. I would beg to differ. I don't think many more people would care. They would just be like, oh, this guy that the jerked off in like 2016, he's like saying racist stuff on whatever platform Ethan Ralph is streaming on. I mean, good for him. It's not like it's something extreme. It's just like he's not funny. That's the whole thing. He's not funny, and people managed to take him down because not just because he wasn't funny, but because he was just a shitty guy. If you're not funny and you're kind of an all right person, nobody's gonna really bother you all that much. They might say that you're not funny and your joke sucks, but they're not gonna go past that line. But with him, it was like, well, he's a piece of shit, and also he is not funny, and also it's racist. Well, that's why it happens. It's how life works. And big ups to Silver Cyborg for the 5 gifts, dude. Thank you. I think, is this a new month? Can I send my free memberships? Oh, I don't have them. I've given them all away this month. So, sorry, guys. Next month. Come back in like a week.
Stop. Cancel culture shit, right?
But or on Friday.
My content today has evolved, all right? And here's the thing. It's evolved to the point where I'm no longer in line.
You can be funny cracking dark humor jokes.
Absolutely.
Big Roach just doesn't understand what's funny and goes for the most obvious stereotype without any thought behind it.
Yeah, I mean, jokes shouldn't be like super, super obvious and easy to tell. And all his jokes are obvious and super surface level. That's why nobody respects his humor. That's why he can't even legitimately laugh at his own jokes. He needs the fake laugh. Because he doesn't even find it funny. He just says things that people might find funny because he has some idea of what is funny and what's not.
With what most people on YouTube want. Because most people on YouTube want immature drama crap. That's not me, right? That's like saying you were going to make a TV show. And so you made a TV show that was professionally made.
And now again, instead of arguing the actual current situation, we have to talk about some fantasy analogy that doesn't make sense.
All kinds of interesting plots.
So in these analogies, what's interesting is that he's just creating a reality that is not similar to what has happened to him, but it makes it easier for him to make his point. Because the point in the current situation, if we talk specifically, doesn't work, but in an abstract fake situation, it works.
And good vibes and things, but it doesn't get a lot of attention. But then someone made Keeping Up with the Kardashians the dumbest, most vapid, empty-headed piece of dog shit television ever created.
He hasn't watched a single episode, by the way. I have watched multiple. It's not a good show, but I mean, he's just hating on shit he knows nothing about. Just because he's heard the word Kardashian and he knows it's associated with bad.
And that's the most popular thing on TV. So that's it's the right not. Way to go, and you should keep making that, right?
The Kardashians are not very popular on TV.
666. Him talking about this going on and on is immature.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. It's just like, I don't get the his obsession with defending all the shit that he said back in the day and how people were and shit like that. I just don't get it.
I've made the most vapid, shitty content on YouTube back in the day. I know that now.
Wait, I thought that was great content. That's your legacy. Really? And now it's just the most vapid, shitty content on YouTube. But also, if you talk about, like, hateful slurs and racist jokes, he would just say that he made only a couple of them. And most of his other gameplay didn't have anything like that. But now it's he's just shitting on his own stuff.
And I've matured and I've
God damn. Up. But what's with the throwback channel then? Because the throwback channel is based around setting a spotlight on the shitty, vapid piece of shit content he used to do back in the day. And convincing us that it was amazing. And it was a classic. He's trying to convince you that the fucking Heavy Rain playthrough is a classic. But it's also a vapid piece of shit content.
From that kind of content. I don't want to make constant sex jokes.
None of this makes sense. None of this works. It just doesn't.
I don't want to make constant racial jokes. I don't want to be making these offensive comments for the sake of getting a rise out of people anymore.
Uh-huh. And now he's acting like he was doing it by force and not him trying to be impressive. It's kind of like Wings of Redemption, because Wings is another fucking complete bum-ass loser who just says things to seem more interesting than he really is, because he's not interesting at all. You can replace him with a fucking inflatable mattress and it's going to be the same experience. You can fucking replace him with a beanbag chair and it's going to be the same experience, just like with DSP.
Past that. In fact, if you look at my demographics,
they're just saying stuff to be interesting. And then they become interesting technically because they get people's attention in a negative way. And then they're like, well, why are you fucking toxic to me? Well, because you tried to get my attention and you did.
You too? All right. You will see that my demographics over the years have completely changed. My audience in 2010 was a bunch of teenagers. Uh-huh. I know, because I used to pull the demographics and always used to say, yeah, all of your viewers are teenagers, right? Now I pull my demographics and it says, whoa, now
this
most of
probably
my...
watched Vanderpump Rules and the Hills with Kat while he gave her that weird tickle pet and telling the baby he's so much prettier than Lauren Conrad. He does literally everything he talks in opposition of I wouldn't doubt at all.
Well, I don't know what Vanderpump Rules and the Hills is, so I actually don't know. Is it a porno? Is it some vintage thing? Oh, that I'm gonna look it up. But Vikes is on thin ice, so he might be sending me a curveball. Vanderpump Rules. Oh, reality TV. Okay, I get it. Yeah, this shit looks like the Kardashians if they were smart. I don't know. Okay, I get it now.
Viewers are in their mid-20s to mid-30s or mid-30s to 40s.
Yeah, bro, but first of all, are you getting dressed up for those guys? Are you blowing bubbles to those guys? Are you eating food on camera with those guys pretending you guys are having a pizza party together? That's kind of awkward. I haven't really done that with my friends. And also, people lie on the internet so they can bypass age-restricted content. Yeah. Yeah. So I hate to break it to you, Phil, but those analytics are just not legitimate.
That's where all of my viewers are.
All of my viewers, by the way.
Older people, adults.
Adults.
My age range.
Do you have to explain to adults what produce is in the supermarket? Really? Do you have to explain to them what Costco is? I don't know, Phil. I wouldn't harp on the age of your audience too much because you quite literally talk to them as if they're mentally disabled. Well, because some of them are, but still.
Who are looking for a different kind of content, right? That's what people want. They do not want trash, stupid drama on this channel, right? Now, there are people who want trash and stupid drama. They're not my viewers. They're my haters. They're scumbags out there. And that's literally, why do you think the top YouTubers right now are people who are doing drama shit constantly.
How do you know who the top YouTubers are, Phil? You don't watch YouTube. Again, we're just making shit up. Because drama is... I mean, I don't even blame them if they're the top YouTubers, because drama is fucking entertaining. I'm not on the internet to have fucking deep, meaningful conversations about fucking politics and changing people's minds. I'm on the internet to relax, especially on YouTube.
Even the gamers. I mean, the gamers are constantly causing drama, doing drama stunts and things. That's how-
$2 from Kopsai Defal. Older, very special. Adults, wheelchair, access, wheelchair, access, wheelchair.
Yeah,
access,
actual, wheelchair, actual access. People that you need to talk to, like, as if they're cat.
They are. That's what...
Probably you don't want to dwell on that.
Teenagers like. That's not the content that I make. Okay? I've grown and evolved over the years.
Uh-huh.
I understand what this person is saying. But again, sadly, this is something you'll come to a realization about in life, okay? Things change. They do. People change. Things change for the better, all right?
Yeah, but the whole thing, remember the prepare the slave trade segment? That was about you not changing. And I think a lot of people missed out on that when they watched the side-scroller interview, because if you look at the comments, most people are sending heat towards Craig and Adam because they brought up the whole slave trade clip when it was just a shitty joke. But the whole point of that is that this guy, for the last 10 minutes before they showed him this clip, was repeating all over and over and over again how much he changed, how much of a better person he is, and how much he hates the person that he once was. So now we're just flip-flopping on a daily basis between him in the past was like the worst. At his lowest point ever, he was an alcoholic, he was depressed, he was fucking racist, sexist, everything. But then the next day, we have a stream on the DSP throwback channel, and those videos that he used to make are now classics. He was a workaholic, he was like really so busy all the time, and all these other positive things. It just switches on a dime.
If you're looking for someone who's now... been through the YouTube grinder. 16 years of my life I've been doing this. I have all the experience, all the knowledge.
No. Just because you're doing something for a long time doesn't mean you're good at it. In a lot of cases, you're going to be stuck in a position at your job simply because you're not good enough for, you know, a bigger position, a better place in the company. So, Phil, if you've been 16 years and the only thing that happened is your business became smaller, less profitable, and less appealing to, you know, your target demographic, then actually you're not doing good. It's a bad thing you're talking about.
Games industry works. I know about all this shit. If that's the kind of stuff that you want to hear, you want to come here and see honest takes on games. You want to hang out with me for a podcast every day and have some honest discourse about things going on in the...
I like how he harps about honesty, and that's what usually narcissists do, because... I mean, I don't really care about the honest opinion of a person who is delusional. His brain is fundamentally dishonest because it interprets things in a way that people don't, in a very different way. So, I mean, like, his honesty is kind of worthless.
World, you want to have some fun laughing at the past on the throwback channel. You want me to laugh at and react to content from all over the internet on the React Show DSP versus the internet. This is the kind of content you could get. It's not going to be mainstream content. That's not what YouTubers are looking for. Excuse me. This is not what YouTube viewers are looking for. They're looking for the same vapid, drama, crap content that I was making 15 years ago.
But how do you know?
Not me anymore. I'm 41, about to be 42.
And again, guy who doesn't watch anybody else, he doesn't explore YouTube and the different communities and niches of content you can have. He just tells you because he decided this is how people watch YouTube. He tells you his idea of how people watch YouTube. And Big Shock is fucking delusional. It's inaccurate. And the only thing it's being used up for is for him to prop himself up as being better than those people.
Okay? So that's why it's different. And again, when people say to me, oh, you changed for the worse, you're boring now, then it's time to move on. Right?
If and again, like again, I'm telling my customers to stop buying my product.
Come as a person, despite the fact that I feel my content is more meaningful today than it ever was before. It's not harmful to anyone. That's a key factor. When you're watching my gameplay, when you're watching my podcast or my react stuff, there's no one getting hurt, right?
Really?
I'm not causing drama. I'm not trying to cause fights and stuff, right?
He's not causing drama, but somehow... And somehow every year he has multiple segments on his podcast responding to drama and participating in it.
I like
$4.99 from Raman Brahman. It points out the contradiction. He has both changed and not changed when he needs to convince you of something.
That's exactly it. That is exactly it. Depending on the situation, he's either changed and completely redeemed himself and he's born again, or he hasn't changed a bit and he's still the same guy and he still puts out the same content he's been. So you should support him.
I like that a lot. The fact that when every day I can go to sleep and say, hey, I didn't actually have to hurt anyone to make a dollar today, right? What? Didn't have to insult anyone. Didn't have to cause any problems for anyone.
No, you insult plenty of people on a daily basis.
I was just able to entertain an audience and make a living doing it.
That's not exactly what happens here. I think you're taking advantage of your audience. I think a lot of those people would not support you if you did not struggle financially. That's, I think, a very big point against DSP, is that a lot of those cucks, if he was not having issues with money, or at least didn't talk about having issues with money, those people wouldn't give him any money at all.
That's an honest paycheck. That's an honest day's work right there, right? Unlike the shit that they're doing on these popular YouTube channels, I'm being honest about it, right? Like I said, I'm basically the blue collar content creator busting my ass.
And again, oh my God, the blue collar content creator. I want him shot out of a cannon into the Grand Canyon.
Hard every day.
I want him shot out of a slingshot.
Not hurting anyone.
Like right into space.
Just making a living, getting by, and hanging out with you guys. And that's what it's all about.
And that's all what right? It's all about. He just called Ann Lead an idiot like 5 minutes ago, by the way.
But I'm not hurting anyone. I'm not calling anybody names. I'm not insulting them. Sounds good.
They do out there pulling their stunts, being fake, doing all this fucking bullshit, scamming and all this shit. I'm not involved with any of that.
Oh, man. And the whole thing is that he talks about these people as if they're like a cabal of nameless, faceless entities. He probably knows who he's talking about particularly, but he is too afraid to call them out. He's too afraid to name drop. Because the moment he name drops, he knows he's going to get clipped beyond belief. People are going to send all those clips to that person that he name dropped. And that person might just turn around and say, wow, look, it's DSP. Is that guy that jerked off? And then everybody's going to laugh but Phil.
I hope that you understand and appreciate that I'm different. All right? So, yeah.
You're different in all the bad ways, Phil. And he is different in all the ways that the trolls can appreciate, and pretty much nobody else.
If that's the case and you don't get it and you don't like the modern me, then it's time to move on. People change it in time, man. It's, you know, it's like they say, a lot of people who I used to watch back in the day have changed. The angry video game nerd absolutely changed. The nostalgia critic changed. Fuck, Howard Stern apparently is...
Did the nostalgia critic actually change, though? He's still doing the same gimmick with the same interpretations of media he used to do, with the same characters, with the same skits. I don't know about nostalgia critic. Well, the thing that he changed is that he's not allowed to use movie clips in the videos anymore because they get claimed.
Completely different today than what it used to be. If you don't like what people become as they evolve, that's fine. That's just the human condition, is that things change over time. You have to accept it. Just don't sit there denying it or demanding that the past comes back. That's never going to happen. I'm never going to be Phil from 2010 again. It just won't happen. It's not going to happen. It can't happen. You understand? I'm a different person. Okay.
All right. Is that it?
Edit your throwback videos into longer...
No, we don't. We're not going to...
Code one video.
Wait. Hold on. This is amazing, actually.
Of editing. Three long parts.
Okay.
That way you can get through older places.
We're going to hear this segment.
Chapters. People can always go back and finish the video. For perspective here, the content on the DSP Throwback channel, all right? Right now, we're making 30-minute parts, okay?
To make
those 30-minute parts takes 4 to 5 hours of video of editing. Just running it through the editor, encoding it.
4 to 5 hours. You guys are fucking schizophrenic. You guys need to get a better PC or something. If it takes you 4 hours for a 30-minute video that you don't actually edit. You run it through some application that upscales it automatically.
Okay?
You don't actually have to go through the pixels and make them bigger or make more of them. More like, make more of them.
Can you imagine if right now, for the Final Fantasy 13 playthrough, which is around 35 hours long, that we tried to make a 12-hour video, the PC would be running for 2 weeks.
No, not really. It's a 12-hour video. Shit would be done in like 24 hours.
Just to encode one video. It wouldn't work.
No, you would have... Dude, you guys are legitimately fucking hopeless. So you're gonna upscale all your clips first, right? Then just put them in a timeline already upscaled and just render it all as one single video. It's much easier and it's gonna be so much faster.
What you're saying is preposterous.
And this is, by the way, the guy who hasn't done a day of editing in his life since 2016.
Maybe if I had a giant network of supercomputers, right?
Uh-huh, yes, farm. Right. A server farm.
Trying to...
To render a 12-hour video, I'm sure. In the year of 2024. That's exactly how it works.
Fucking encode the video, maybe. That it's never going to happen. Okay?
I think the suggestion box is going to end up being the finishing touch to completely destroying his fan base. Because if you can watch him shoot down feedback like this and you still support him, you are a doormat. You are just as good of as a doormat. You are completely worthless and you have no self-respect to yourself.
I don't know what to tell you. But yeah.
Imagine letting this guy talk to you like that. This guy. This dude. This man with the fucking tits. With the tits.
Basically...
And just talking to you like that on a shitty little... Look at a fucking layout. Looks like a children's daycare. It looks like a...
People...
It looks like a pedophile that ended up in a daycare, but there was nobody in it. So he's mad that there's nobody in the daycare. And he's just lashing out on everybody.
Just have these crazy misconceptions about things. Oh, it should be so easy to do that content. Really? You think that taking those videos that look and sound atrociously bad, like some of them you can't even make out what I'm saying in the video at this point, because now, you know, years later, you're so used to the modern technology, it looks like shit, it sounds like shit. You
okay.
Think that running those videos through upscaling AI, through noise correcting AI.
Noise correcting AI. My boy, it's called... A noise gate filter. This is some shit that runs on OBS in real time. So no, that is not dealing a big hit on your performance. It's just factually is not.
Right? Then combining them together, that this should take like 20 minutes.
No, not 20 minutes. Probably an hour. Well, you're not really doing all that much. You're letting the computer do everything for you.
Well, let me know what alternative universe you live in. I'd like to...
Wow, look at this guy, man.
Where everything is like this. Really, I'd love to see it. It doesn't exist, but I'd love to know. Because, again, these people are living in an alternate reality when they think about this shit. They just want... what it's called? It's called instant gratification.
Oh, my God.
I want it my way, immediately, for free. And if you don't give it to me my way immediately for free, you're doing it all wrong and it's your fault.
Phil? That kind of sounds like you taking feedback, bro. That's exactly what happens when you take feedback, bro. I want it now. I want it the way that I want it. And everything else, you're doing it wrong.
Right? Listen.
Sounds good.
The way I see it is, the way that those videos are releasing is good. It gives you a little bit of content.
And also the whole thing for free. No, Phil, they are all paying your bills. As long as you're doing this for free as a full-time job, every single one of those viewers, even the ones that don't give you money, are paying your bills. That's just how it works. That's your viewer base that is paying your bills. Even if it's just 1 minute, man, and only iced coffee.
To every day, half an hour, right?
So yeah, just keep going on and on. And in the end, there's not going to be anybody to pay your bills.
It doesn't overwork the editors. So they're not having to pump 20, 30, 40 hours into each video, which would be ludicrous. Do you know how many views those videos are getting? On average, 100 to 200. Do you really think that we should run it through an editor for that long?
This sounds like this channel is not worth developing, and you should just cut your losses and just end it.
To get 100 views on a video? What are you talking about?
Sounds right? Like it's a shitty-ass channel. If you're taking, like... 4 hours of video and they get 100 views, you should just stop. You're wasting somebody's time. Somebody spends 4 hours to send you some dog shit ass videos and then you get to put them up and nobody sees them. Yeah, you're literally making somebody work for you for free. and you're just wasting their time.
Like, you're out of your mind. This way, we can guarantee new content every day, right? Because they're half an hour parts. And there's no lull. If you're interested in the playthrough, you can keep following it and watching it. Why on earth would we try to pump that much effort into those videos, edit it for 2-3 days straight to pump out a 5-6 hour video that's going to get 100 views, right? Like, what are you talking about? Again, please give me instant gratification of every single thing that I want with absolutely no rationale of why that would make sense or even any kind of understanding of what you're doing on the channel. Just give it to me now. No.
Well, bro, they explained to you the rationale behind why it's a good idea, so you don't have to upload 1,000 million videos, and it's going to be much easier for people to watch the whole playthrough. Like, quite literally. And then he says no.
We'll not do that.
In, like, a defiant way. It's, like, defiant, spoiled brat way to say no. Because there's good ways of just rejecting this suggestion, because not all suggestions should be implemented, not all of them are good or relevant. But, like, he goes the extra step to be disrespectful about it and just completely shut it down and just even call you an idiot.
Okay. Shorten the podcast and dive into gameplay sooner. That one I've
literally
heard 1,000 times. We've already.
Yeah, if you've heard it 4,000 times and you only have 500 people watching your streams, then it must be really bad, Phil.
We explain that in reality, a lot of the support and engagement that I'm getting these days on certain streams.
So it's money. So that's it. He needs to waste as much time collecting your money.
Instant gratification when he says he improved his stream by getting a 480p webcam, a ring light, string lights, and a new vest, all thing given to him at no cost to him whatsoever. When low tops, he says, I improved, why aren't you tipping me?
You know what? And he does shit like this. Even when he started dressing up better, when LTG clowned on him and he started dressing up in shirts like this. I mean, like, what the fuck is this? But still, he's sitting there and he's constantly bringing it up to fish for support and to fish for attention and compliments. So yes, he quite literally always wants instant gratification. That's why he's addicted to gacha games. That's the epitome of instant gratification.
Cast, there's been certain...
He's got like a 98% win rate in WWE Champions, dude. 98% of all time. And in the last 30 days, it's probably 99.3 or something.
Days when I talk and we have a good conversation and good fun and I get support and I start the game and it's dead. Right now, we are leaning more towards content outside of the raw gameplay. This is going to continue to happen.
Your audience is rejecting that content. Yesterday, you made like $30 for like, what, 3 hours of reacting or something? They don't fucking want it. They don't want it, bro. I don't give a fuck if you got carpal tunnel. You gotta get a job because this shit's not gonna work out. You're not good at watching videos. You're not good at reacting. You're not talented. You don't have good commentary. You're not humorous. You're not an interesting person with a lot of things happening to them. You just kind of exist there to press buttons because those people in the chat cannot do it themselves. In some cases, literally, if we're talking about Jade.
Future. So... Oh, just get rid of the podcast. Shorten the podcast. It's the opposite is what's going to happen because that's what actually what's going on is there's more support. Last week, you guys literally voted to have a chill night with me. All we did was talk, and it went well.
Yes, because your gameplay of Tekken 8 is so dog shit. They would rather have 2 hours worth of Q&A. And also, you kind of have to admit, there was probably plenty of trolls that voted on the poll.
That stream went well. So why are you getting at me a comment here? Drop the podcast. Make a shorter podcast. No, people want more. That's what I'm seeing. The actual...
Really?
28 before React and ended with 32.
Oh my God, really? And 25 of that is 1 minute, man. 25 is just one dude. Oh my God, this is gonna... damn. All we need is like a pattern... just a pattern of no drama happening to him, so he has nothing to milk for money. And just a couple weeks of, like, slow games, and he's just... Oh, man, the begging is gonna be... It's gonna be extinction-level event. The fucking begging.
Versus this kind of one-off suggestion, the evidence is people are liking it more. So do more.
Oh, no, he's doing literally the opposite of what people want to do, and giving you this face.
Because, well, somebody said they wanted more.
But the real The real excuse is he doesn't want to play games and he wants to quote unquote diversify, but nobody's buying it because it's fucking stupid and he got nothing to offer. And at the same time, like he said, he makes most of his money during the podcast. So he feels like the more podcasts he does, the more money he's going to make because that's how his brain works. That's just how smart he is. Big ups Infidel Castro for the membership, dude.
Oh, let's see here. So this one actually is a good one. It says, you should try diving into YouTube analytics. By the way, this should probably be the last suggestion we take for today because I got to get the shout outs and stuff.
Oh, thank God.
YouTube analytics for podcasts. See what segments of the show have spikes or dips in viewer retention. Does the retention start to go down when you bring up a schedule? Consider shortening that segment. Does the retention spike when you discuss gaming news? Consider covering more gaming news or even expand into entertainment news. My robo-generated timestamp.
He's gonna a dude that doesn't consume any kind of entertainment is gonna expand into entertainment news. What is he gonna talk about? Oh, well, I guess there's a new movie coming out. It's called Dune. And, well, I haven't watched the first one. And this is like Dune 2. And I guess it has like Timothy Shubba 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 in it. And Zendaya. And I don't even know these people. I mean, like, I don't know why you fucking idiots want me to talk about this. This looks fucking stupid. What are they doing? They're like on the beach and there's like worms and stuff. And like, I don't fucking get it, man. There's like so many fucking sexualized, stupid ass content nowadays. That was just like how it's gonna sound.
It's likely help with these stats.
The guy who legitimately, he might as well just be living on a different planet. And you give him like a newspaper and you made him read the article headlines.
From Down Forward Punch, Review Hogan's USA.
Oh, Review Hogan's USA. Yeah, if he completely ran out of ideas, he could just resort to wrestling. Because wrestling is super easy to talk about. It's super easy to talk about. You basically have the same talking points over and over again.
He outright refused to talk about Madam Web.
Well, what are you going to say about it? I mean, it's a movie that pretends to be in the MCU, but it's not because it's a Sony movie. And it's also everything about it is bad. And it has hot women in it. Like, why do you expect him to talk about it? This literally has attractive girls in it. He doesn't watch them.
Encouraging people.
He just watches gay porn because that's the straightest form of content you can watch.
To parts of the podcast that interest them.
He only watches gay porn and he sometimes occasionally gets an erection. Just sometimes. That means
retention
he's straight.
Parts they want to skip past and raising retention for parts they want to watch. On a video's analytics page, there's a retention graph under engagement tab. The graph can provide valuable information as to who actually tunes into the podcast and why.
Bro is explaining to him what analytics is. This is insane.
Successful. Consider sifting through the retention graphs for multiple podcast episodes to recognize patterns in audience interest.
Oh my God, you could have just said, look at your fucking analytics.
All really good constructive criticism.
Uh-huh.
I want to do that. My challenge is twofold.
What is he going to say? Oh, he's going to say he doesn't have enough time, is it?
The first challenge of this is finding time to do it.
Oh my God, no. No. God damn it.
When I'm already sitting here in this office... 8 to 10 hours a day streaming.
Dude, it takes you like 30 seconds to pull up the app on your phone. Go on the analytics tab and go on your latest video and see what part of the video people watch the most and when they dropped out. It takes like 30 seconds. And this dude already talking about it like he's chained in the fucking basement all day.
Uploading. Schedule. All this stuff, right?
Schedule. What about it? What about the schedule? What about it takes more than 5 minutes? What about uploading a video takes more than 10 minutes? What about it?
Of the vast majority of my time.
He's got legitimately 16 hours a day of time where he can distribute what he's going to do, everything, you know, his whole schedule for the day. 16 hours. And you're telling me that that's taken up by him doing a schedule image that he's gonna post on Twitter and also uploading videos? I don't understand it. Everything he has to do in a day, including streaming, takes him a maximum of 10 hours.
Already with what I'm doing, I don't know when I'm going to find time to sit and sift through analytics. Now, I'd love to do this.
There we go. And now we're talking about sifting through analytics. It's like he's gonna be making presentations for the shareholders. He's going to be reaching out to professional statisticians.
I'm curious.
They are 1.5-hour episodes on many of the major stars of the 90s and prior like Stone Cold. All of them are very well made. You'd enjoy all of them.
I think I would. I think I should start with the Dark Side of the Ring first, because there's a new episode coming up, a new season, and I like the darker stories, because wrestling is a very crazy business and a lot of like dark, shady, fucked up stuff happens, and I want to know about it.
Yes, if you could do it on the phone, like in the app, because I don't think you can. I think you have to do it actually in the real YouTube dashboard. Like, I have analytics in the YouTube apps and stuff that I have, but it's not the full-fledged stuff. It's like a mobile downgraded version. But I'd have to look into this, okay? I would. I'd have to dive in. So, for example, what I could do, this very podcast, let it sit for a day or two, right? Go and look at the analytics, and there's engagement analytics, and see, when did people come in and watch? When did they, when was their spikes? When were their dips? You know, what happened? That's what I got to figure out.
But the thing is, right, the thing with this podcast is that there's not specific pacing, you know? It's not like it's separated into well-distinguishable segments. Because, like, sometimes he's going to start talking about schedule and then jump to talking about something else and then about something else and then something else. And then he's going to end that topic and bring it up later, like, 10 minutes after. It's just such a mess. I don't think he's going to be very happy with what he's gonna find, and I think his watch time is gonna be very low. That's what I think.
Other challenge, and this sadly is a big challenge, okay, is knowing the fact that sadly I'm not just making content for me, I'm making content that goes into other circles. And here's what I mean by that: detractors. Every what? Single day when I'm streaming, there's thousands of people rewatching this stream on someone else's stream, and when something gets said that's inflammatory, like, for example, let's say, I don't know, Tevin is restreaming me today, and there's some particular meme he brings up, or there's something that I'm saying, a topic that he finds interesting, right? So then he'll bring it up on his stream. All of a sudden, some of his viewers will jump onto my stream.
Really? Right? No, that, when has that happened? No, they just sit in Tevin's chat and they talk to each other. Why would they fucking jump onto his stream? That doesn't make any sense.
And what happens is that...
So wait, those people are what? Now the trolls are ruining his analytics and are making them unreliable?
$2 from Kopsai Defal. You should start with the plane ride from hell.
You know, I think so, definitely. Because I've heard of that story from Cornette, but not the whole thing.
Use the audience, all right? And by the way, I just said Tevin because he's a common restreamer. Everyone says that he's someone who restreams me all the time for stuff, right? So basically what'll happen is there'll be spikes. Like, I'll even see, oh my God, I would look, why on earth do I have like 600-700 viewers right now? I don't even understand it. Like, where did that come from, right? And you'd be like, well, that's because someone was restreaming you. They said a comment about what you were saying, and so their viewers came over to see your stuff, right? To comment in the chat themselves or whatever.
But no, that doesn't happen. That is, if it happens, it's like, it's not a trend. It's not something that it's known people do. And I mean, I've been around to know. People just sit in the chat of the person they're watching.
You'll know.
Sometimes somebody would try and get someone else's attention by giving you like shout outs. Like, he would go from Tevin's stream and give Tevin a shout out on DSP stream. That's a thing that happens. But outside of that, it's not, there's no like troll raids where it's like, hey, fucking, the DSP took a sip. Go and tell him, guys, how fucking silly he looks.
It's all of a sudden, there'll be a ton of accounts that will come into the chat and all start saying the same thing. And that's because you know where they came from. They came from a restreamer stream. And that's,
or maybe you legitimately said a thing that they were, I guess, shocked by, or it got a reaction out of them.
Use the data. So it sucks because, for example, if you're trying to use analytics to figure out, oh, I wonder, you know, what really was the
most
engaging...
from Devilman 666. Hail Satan.
Yeah, big ups to the mean guy with the big tail. Big ups. Wow, he's the goat. Speaking of Satan, I don't know why this reminded me of that. I watched a video about J Station, by the way, my favorite YouTuber, the guy who drank the gay potion at 3 a.m. And it turns out, like, this dude has done so much more toxic fucking shit than I thought. To the point where it's like, there's speculation of him actually like selling his soul to the devil and shit. Go check it out.
Part of the podcast,
fucking J
right?
Station.
And it'll be,
oh, hey guys, today I'm gonna drink the gay potion at 3 a.m. guys.
Oh, it's when someone tipped a dollar. And
oh yeah, and he also faked his girlfriend's death for views. That was a prank they did. They pretended she was dead, like actually dead for real.
Talking about Review Tech USA in a negative way.
And he was also in a coma, like for fake.
On it, but in reality, your viewers don't care about that. That's the detractors. They care about that content, so they came to the stream to see it.
Bro, how are you doing this shit for 15 years? You still don't know what your viewers care about and what the trolls care about. Like, how the fuck are you still that stupid? How the fuck are you so behind?
But your viewers didn't give two shits. Your real supportive viewers. That's a problem. There's no way to tell in analytics where your real engagement is coming from. Like, what did my actual viewers and fans who are here every day, what did they like about my show today? That you can't tell, really, you know, because you're going to get those spikes and those interferences from outsiders. How many people can say every time that they put out content on YouTube, there's 1,000 people watching them on other streams that could skew their analytics at any moment? Right? Probably not many. Maybe me and a few other people who get restreamed all the time. Like,
I mean, no.
Like that. Probably a few of us. But not that many, right? We're in a unique situation where these tools, sadly, don't get used as much because we can't really use them because they get thrown for a loop whenever that kind of stuff happens, right? But I like the suggestion, I guess, because it would be a lot easier for me to do this stuff, for example, on my phone. Like, let's say, for example...
Oh, my... Okay, you know, I'm done with this, man. I'm done with this. Because today, I actually have to be in a very positive mood because tonight, I'm going to my mom's birthday. And she's officially 50 years old, dude. So it's like 50-year legacy. I should be very positive. So I'm just going to end the fucking stream right now. Because otherwise, I'm going to get mega toxic. So yeah, this is it. Thanks, everybody, for watching. I'm going to go get ready, do the stuff I got to do for the rest of my day off. And I'll see you next time. Until then. Yong out.